we need to get in here.
You asked me what time it was, motherfucker. Don't turn that around on me.
Trying to brush my teeth in the bathroom, and he says, let's go, let's go, let's go.
Oh, we're late. We got people waiting. You know, we got people calling in already and shit. Are we taking... We can't take calls this early.
Not yet.
But, I would advise everybody watching...
Yes?
Not to adjust your screen.
Why?
Because you really are looking... Face. You really are looking at two legends. I mean, rock and roll icons. Future Hall of Famers.
How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. A little drunk.
Yes.
Won't lie.
Drinking for a long time now.
Not a long time. I started about 5:30.
I always tell you to pace yourself so that when we get to like 10 or 11 o'clock.
Pace yourself, Matt Boone. They clash, bro.
What happened here? Did the laptop and everything reboot on me? I think the computer might have rebooted.
Oh, you know what it was? Sometimes it pops up with the Windows update.
And then automatically you can say
remind me again in 20 minutes, 4 hours.
Is that what I'm... God, I hope he still... Hey, that Wi-Fi still works, so that's good.
What are we giving him this week? What do we got going on?
Monday Night Raw from last night.
The UFC,
I watched bits and pieces of it, dude. But I went to bed early on Saturday.
I went to bed extremely early that night. I went to bed like 10:30. Yeah. Yeah. So, and I was going to watch just the main event because I didn't give a shit about the undercard. Mm. It was a weak card. Mm. It turned out to be an amazing show.
Those are always the cards, though, dude, that...
Sometimes.
That never...
There was a while where, like, you could guarantee a shitty card would be good, and then there was plenty of times after that where shitty cards were shitty.
Right.
But, yeah, so now, like, you kind of have to gamble. Like, am I going to miss, like, the... And as it turns out, I went to sleep and woke up and found out that it was maybe one of the best fights of all time.
I was awake for the...
You saw
main event. I missed the first round, and then I woke up because the announcers were screaming. I was kind of laying in my bed, but I had it on in the background.
Who were the announcers for that show?
John Anik and whoever he does it with. It was that commentary team. It wasn't Mike Goldberg and Joe Rogan.
You know who John Anik used to work for?
Was it Bellator?
ESPN.
No. Oh, ESPN.
ESPN.
Yeah.
Do SportsCenter and all that. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. No doubt. But I heard it was a very good show.
It's weird to see the internet right here now.
It is. Yeah. Right. Well, right.
You
I like
used
it.
To having to do phones.
You know
this.
What I did watch, dude? Because
what did you watch?
I watched Ring of Honor, the Global Wars iPay-per-view
event. That was on
event.
The same time, right?
Yeah.
You
yeah.
were flipping back and forth. I caught it through the wall. Yeah.
I caught the Ring of Honor right after the intermission. It is hot. I will give it to you now. And I got a long sleeve.
I told you,
shirt
the only reason
there.
It wasn't because I had the air running. He comes in, you got the air conditioner on? I said, dude, it's hot as fuck in here.
60 something degrees today.
But I don't have curtains, so the sun beats through the room all day and it makes it hotter.
Yeah. Well, anyways. So,
better than you having your window open and dogs jumping out the fucking thing.
Oh, the dogs got loose yesterday, man.
And today, Reggie went out.
Maintenance crew was not happy yesterday. He gave me a real attitude. I said, I'm sorry, I don't know how they got out. He says, you got your screen out of your window, man.
It's just laying there.
I said, dude, they don't fucking fit. Yeah. The screens don't fit in the window. So, what, you know?
Tape it.
That's what I'm going to have to do. Or
just for appearance.
Group.
Like, it's not going to work. Reggie could walk right through it if it's taped. But if it looks like it's sitting there, then you can't get yelled at.
Get me a new screen. That would be the way to solve
that's what
the
you did. You tell the maintenance man, I need a new screen.
Well, we have. We told them numerous times.
Have you?
Yeah.
Well, then why haven't
numerous.
They given
me one? I don't know. I don't know.
Tell them to shut the fuck up. And what are they
been? You know, I've been sick for about the past
week. Yeah, I don't like sitting this close to you because you were unbelievably sick. Like, pitifully sick. Like, moaning. You know.
I got sick last Monday, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I came on here on Tuesday and we drank some beers and I felt better. I woke up Wednesday morning, man, and maybe it was a hangover in addition to the sickness.
Yeah,
Wednesday was terrible, right? Wednesday and Thursday were the worst. Friday, I come down, I'm feeling a little bit better on Friday, but I come down with this, I mean, don't make your gauging. I couldn't swallow. I couldn't eat food. I couldn't drink. I could not swallow for the life.
I don't like to eat or drink.
It hurts, man. Yeah. It hurts so fucking bad, man. I'm like, what is going on? And then all weekend long, and then Sunday comes around, and I lost my voice.
I was going to say, if people know the show and they listen regularly,
yeah,
I'm drunk, so I'm going to try and work on not interrupting you too much, unless I got really something good to say.
Did you listen last week or not?
No, I didn't. All right. I could swear I know the week before it was ridiculous that I interrupted a lot, but last week I don't think I because I remember being conscious the whole show, like, wait from the finish, and then go. But if people listen to the show or watch the show on a regular basis, they can hear it. I can hear it sitting right next to you.
Is that sticky?
Yeah,
oh, it
man.
Is sticky. All right,
I got some gel found. Right. But
just wondering.
You can hear your voice crackling in certain spots. So you can tell that you've either lost your voice or you're regaining your and it's regaining.
It's coming back, man. But on Sunday I lost it, and then yesterday it was pretty bad. Today it's finally coming back. But I think I'm finally over whatever it was. I think it was strep throat because Haley had
you have me looking
throat.
At the tonsils. There was no spots on them.
Well, that's what somebody on Facebook
we
said. Check
her,
the back of your throat to see if there's white dots.
Do you remember? I remember she was on the couch, your niece Haley, and your sister Allison said, look at her throat. And we looked at her throat, and she clearly had white spots all over.
Yeah, she did.
You see this guy put on a fucking dramatic performance, too. Like, when his voice went... He's like, dude, I can't.
Wait. That was extra. That wasn't because the voice went, man. I couldn't talk. It hurt, man.
Yeah.
Dude, to swallow. I'm telling you. You ever get that
him.
When you have a sore throat and you try to swallow and you're like, Jesus, that fucking hurts.
I just
hurts.
Got a visual of one of the times you came in here to tell me something and you're like, dude, and he's holding his throat and he's got the depressed look on his face. Dude, I can't.
Next time you get sick.
Oh, I'm a big fucking pussy.
I would wake up at 7 in the morning. I'd have these coughing fits at 7 in the morning. It was bad. And not only that, but normally a sickness lasts for, 1, 2, 3 days.
And
this is going on over a week.
It's been like 2 weeks.
Over a week.
It scares the fuck out of me because if I catch it, I'm worse than you. I'm a fucking pussy when I get sick.
Yeah.
But I will say this, and this is a true statement. There's been plenty of times where you've been sick, and I know exactly how bad it was because I would catch it.
Yeah.
And I would react way worse than you. Like,
I kind of hope you get this one just because of the way you're talking right now.
This
is the way you're talking right now. You going, bitch,
funny.
You baby.
But, there's plenty of time. I'm about to push you over. There's plenty of times, because I've caught it later, where I know exactly what he was going through, and the motherfucker, you wouldn't even know he's sick sometimes. Like, he don't sell it at all.
This one
he's overselling a little bit, to be honest. But there's plenty of times where he won't sell at all, and I'll catch it, and I'll just be fucking worthless. Like, can you go grab me a cup of water? I don't want to get up,
This one hurt, man. This one took me down, but I still worked,
yes,
and I was
did.
A little bit behind. But anyways, so this is what we're going to do. We got
to
talk
chat
about...
Room. You got to mention to the people
that
they watch on the chat page. They can't get the chat working.
Yeah. For those watching the stream, basically...
Who wouldn't be? That's the only place to watch it.
What am I looking for?
You said for those watching on the chat page. That's the only place we have it, so they have to be there. Yeah.
Well, anyways, we installed some extra security on the server. The last couple of days, we've been having the database crashes.
Yes.
And they say it's MySQL.
Yes. MySQL
database. It's very, very high load, right? And
a lot of forums have.
Yeah, no doubt. But so we had database errors, so we installed this extra security. And with that being said, the security, and I didn't find this out until today, right before the show went live, the security does not allow Java.
No. Did it work last night? Because you do the raw chat room. Was it working last night?
I didn't know that it wasn't working last night due to the fact that I used this direct URL.
Yeah, you always go straight
and nobody
to it,
said anything in the chat room. I didn't notice until somebody said something on Facebook just an hour or two ago and said. So anyways, the new security on the server doesn't allow Java. So I need to go back in and find a way to, at least on Tuesday nights, allow the JavaScript to work. So for the time being, the only way that you can get to the chat room is by using the direct URL, and it's kind of...
You didn't
link
it, did you?
I did. You can go to...
on the chat page.
You can go to facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR.
Or...
You got to go to that page directly, and the third post down, there's two top posts. They say, listen to WZR TV right now. The third post down will link you. It'll say something like client16.addonchat.com. If you go to facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR, third post down, you can get that link right there, and then you can come into the chat room.
Or you can go to facebook.com/...
MattBooneWZR.
Exactly. I got the...
You got the link out too?
I had /chat at first.
Yeah.
And then 2 seconds later, because I kept going to WZRonline.com, refreshing, waiting for you to put the chat up, and then I was going to link it. And you were late this week, I think, because it was up fucking like right before we started setting this stuff
up. I was trying to fix the JavaScript.
And you were buying on news too and stuff, so you were trying to get that up first so that it wasn't buried.
Exactly.
But as soon as I saw it go up, I put /chat up, and then 2 seconds later, you put your chat post on Facebook, and you said, yo, we have a problem with /chat, which is how I learned about it, and you had the direct link. I was like, oh shit, let me go fix mine.
I didn't know right up until, you know, we went live. So anyways, so, we got to talk Monday Night Raw from last night. The big news.
And so we got to talk Daniel Bryan.
And let me give props to somebody, and I don't know if he's listening or not, but your boss, guy by the name of Michael...
Shalik.
Okay, Shalik.
I always say Shalik.
Bluth.
It's Shalik.
Shalik, whatever it is. Yesterday...
Oh, yeah, Michael Bluth, if you read this.
A site that I used to own, SCScoops.com.
I always forget that you own that site first.
Yeah, SCScoops.com. I used to own it. Mike contacted me way back in the day, and...
We used to work together.
We used to work together, and Mike...
When I first brought him in, he was working with Shalik.
Right.
Now Shalik's my boss, and you make three times as much money.
Mike was kind of running the website for me, and he asked that, you know, could he take it over?
He had the greatest. And I said, no, sorry to interrupt. He had the greatest domain name, not the .net. I'm not going to bring that up.
Sports Entertainment, right?
No. He had back in the day. He had Wrestling Warzone.
I do remember that. Yeah,
Raw,
man.
War, the Warzone.
Wow.
He had Wrestling Warzone. I was like, yo, that's a badass domain.
I remember Wrestling Hookup. That was Marston's website.
Yeah,
Wrestling
Hookup. You remember my first domain? You weren't even around.
What was
this.
The other one?
What is this?
The other one, the guy with the weird name,
Fritz?
Yes.
WrestlePages.
Yeah.
WrestlePages. I worked for that site, I worked for Hoka. I worked for every fucking site three. But, you know what my very first domain was? And everybody, no, I didn't own that site. I worked for it. But, and they made t-shirts of me. They were trying to market me as a star.
Really?
Nielsen, Sherling,
the
Belgian guy.
You met up with him.
He ended up coming to America and went to Hooters. And he looked like Conan O'Brien. But anyways, I had a domain that everybody said looks like, it sounds like a porn domain. You know what it was called? My very first domain ever.
Was I around at this time?
No.
I don't know.
Hardcoreheadlines.com.
Hardcoreheadlines.com.
Yeah. It was hardcoreheadlines, like .hypermart.net. That was my first website ever, and then I got the domain.
Yeah.
And I thought I was this fucking legend, and then, you know.
It does sound like a porn name. Hardcore Headlines. Yeah, you're looking for headlines.
But that was
on
the day
porn.
Of ECW.
Right.
WWE was really adopting that attitude.
Man, remember the old days where IGN and UGO were paying like $20,000 a month.
Guaranteed CPM of like $4.
$4, $5 CPM. Man. You were making like $20,000 a month.
Fucking forget about it. In WrestleZone, which I finally got, that was like the ultimate.
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
UGO and IGN back in the day, like Boone said, they were paying $4 or $5
CPM. And it was like guaranteed money because you could sign a contract.
Right.
And you were guaranteed like 3 years of $4 CPM.
So,
could you imagine that right now?
So CPM rates are per every 1,000 hits you get on the website,
you get paid
$4
if
or $5. CPM is per every 1,000 hits you get paid a certain rate.
Yeah, and the rate, if you have 4 CPM, which we just referenced, that means every 1,000 hits
$4.
Bang. So if you get 20,000 hits
Not uniques. We're talking page views.
Yeah. You can sit there and refresh your page all fucking day.
If you're talking 20,000 page views a day at $4 CPM, you're looking at...
Like 80 four, bucks, 800 bucks.
$800.
Four Eight. Times two times how many zeros?
And how many page views? Pro Wrestling Scoops... WZRonline.com damn near gets 100,000 page views every day. It gets about... It's not that high. It's not... No. Because WZRonline.com gets about 12,000 unique visitors per
That's
day.
Good.
12,000 different people. And then those people come back about four times a day. So it's only about 60,000
uniques. And you get 60,000 pitches. That's about 12, 24,
it's
20,
about four,
6,
48, four,
6, so like 4.5
four or five page views per visitor.
That's pretty good.
It's pretty good.
Anything around five is like great.
And ProWrestlingScoops.com.
And for those who don't know, page views per
units.
Visitor is every time, like if I log onto the site, if you have 4.8, let's just say 5 pay dues per visitor.
Right.
That means each time a visitor, if I'm the one visitor,
you're one guy.
I load 5 different pages. I click 5 links on your site and load 5 pages. And that's what.
So, anyways, but so back in the day, UGO and IGN, they'd be $4 CPM. Fast forward.
Fuck me, man.
Fast forward.
You're lucky to get a quarter CPM.
Fast forward to 2014, you're lucky to get a quarter.
And that's a great CPM rate these days.
If, you, if you're like, getting,
holy shit, I got 25 cents.
If you're getting 30 cents CPM for every 1,000 right. hits. No. if you get 30 cents for every 1,000 hits, that's considered a pretty fucking good
big
rate.
Time. Yeah. These days, fucking forget about it.
And that's why, in order, like, if you want to make a living off pro wrestling like you and I do, you don't
pro
own
wrestling
your own
internet.
Websites. Right.
Yeah.
But I own my own websites. I wouldn't be able to do this. If ProWrestlingScoops.com didn't get 150,000 to 200,000 page views every day, or if WZR Online didn't get 60,000 page views every day, I wouldn't be making a living here because I'm getting 30 cents CPM. My highest advertising company is like 52 cents CPM, which is amazing.
And it never stays 52. It varies up and down.
It goes
down.
Up and down on a daily basis.
What you're saying is basically, let's say you live check to check, which luckily you don't, because A, you make a shitload of money.
Right.
And I make like, you know, half of what you make. You know, but add it together in one house, and your sister's making money now too. So like, we don't live check to check. We're not like depending on our next check to fucking get a car.
I mean, I make good money.
You make real
good
money.
But I own a network of websites. Yeah. Not only that, but the reason that we have to do so many posts every day, that we do 30 or 40 posts, because the more posts we do, the more page views that translates to, and the more page views, that's what we need to make
money.
And
when you freelance like I do, I get paid per post.
Yeah.
I get a certain amount of money every time I post, so obviously I'm going to try and post a lot.
But let me go back to the original topic.
The whole point I was making there with the amount, you know, we don't live check to check, is because if you did, we would have to, we'd be fucked because we don't know what we're going to make.
Right.
Because the lion's share of the money that comes in this house comes from you. So, and you can't say, well, next month we're going to have this much money because you don't know what your rates are going to be. You don't know what traffic's going to be. So
well,
it's
the
not,
first couple of days
IGO,
of the month always suck, too.
Or UGO and IGN. I'm just doing a broad discussion here. UGO, IGN days, you had a guaranteed CPM, guaranteed contract that you signed, so you knew what you would make. You would make at least this much, maybe more.
Right.
Nowadays, you can't budget because you don't know what your traffic's going to be, what your rates are going to be. You know
what
I mean?
Let me say one more thing before we move on. All the money from these advertising companies is untaxed. So while a lot of you guys go out and you guys have normal jobs and they take money.
Tax season, a lot of people look forward to tax season. Oh, I get my big return. Yeah. Not us.
Not us.
No.
I owe money. I usually owe the state about $4,000 or $5,000, and I owe the feds about 10 or more.
I was gonna say the last time.
So
I gotta pay in.
I gotta pay in between 10 and 15,000. We do all the write-offs and the cable and the internet and the radio show and
as
many write-offs as possible. But I have to pay the IRS and the state of New York thousands of dollars, over $10,000.
Yeah.
Over.
Well,
10
the last time I filed taxes last year, I owed $13,000.
It's crazy.
It was insanity.
It is crazy.
I'm like, holy shit,
I know.
Man.
It's
I don't
ridiculous.
Have $13,000 in the savings account. You know,
it's crazy,
what the
man.
Fuck?
You gotta budget that in
but
as you're making money. Right?
I was told by, and I used H&R Block, I was told that you can get, because you know you have a bank account, when you put your money into your bank account, they can tax it for you.
Right.
Through your bank. Your bank can tax everything you put in.
The bank can do it. You're right.
And then
when
tax season comes, you do get a return because the bank's been taxing for you all the money you put in. You know. All
right, so let's get back to the fuck taxes, fuck the IRS, man, fuck them.
Don't say fuck the IRS.
Yeah, you can't do that.
No.
They
are worse than the fucking mob, bro.
They really are. They are a mob. A lot of people call them the mob.
They are a government fucking bad mob.
Let me say this. So Michael Shalik, used to work for me yesterday.
You worked for him. What are you talking about? Used to work
he
for
worked
him.
For me. He worked for me.
What's
it like? Was SC Scoops. I owned
that
it.
Then, yeah.
I owned
but
it.
You started off working for him.
No, I worked for you. I worked for you.
No, I got you some gigs. But
I owned WZ.net.
Did you own that?
Yes,
I didn't
that was
know
my
that.
Domain.
Okay. All right, so I was backwards. He worked for you. Wow, I'm working for somebody. I'm working for somebody who used to work for somebody that I fucking put on the map.
Yeah.
I'm pathetic.
Yeah, but anyways, so the deal here is Michael Shalik yesterday broke a big story during the afternoon hours
Very
over on SC Scoops. And Daniel Bryan suffered a neck injury and is going to undergo surgery.
It's a wear and tear. Like, nothing specific happened that, oh, he did this and broke his neck.
When did it happen?
That's what I'm saying. It was wear and tear.
Okay. Like, over a period of time?
Yeah, he just fucked himself
up. But why all of a sudden? Why all of a sudden that, oh, we're going to have surgery now?
Because he started having a lot of pain and numbness in his arms and stuff like that. Yeah. And he got himself checked out and was diagnosed with a minor break in his neck. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, he's got to get a...
Minimally invasive surgery.
A minimally invasive procedure, yeah. They got to scrape and claw and
if
fix
we cracked up. Open that window, do you think it would work? Or
no.
What about the AC?
You just bringing mid in. AC would be too noisy.
You think?
Turn it on. Let's see what happens.
Go ahead. All right, let me try it. So, chat Daniel room, Ryan on Thursday.
I'll keep it going. Chat room, WZRonline.com. I guess just go there because the / chat doesn't work. But if you're in the chat room, let us know if this air conditioner, which we just turned on, if it's too noisy.
Quiet version.
Yeah, if it's too noisy, let us know if that like disrupts the audio. But anyways, Daniel Bryan, like you said, the neck and everything.
Yeah, Daniel Bryan. So on Thursday, he's going to undergo minimally invasive.
You have trouble with that word, huh?
Minimally, right?
Minimally, yeah.
Invasive neck surgery. People are saying, they're saying 6 to 8 weeks. The deal here is they're not going to know until they cut him open on Thursday, go in there and see how severe. I mean, they can do MRIs, this, that, and the other thing, but until he goes under the knife and they cut him open, they slice him up, and they get in there and they see what the actual problem is and then stitch him back up. After surgery, then they're going to know, hey, how well did the surgery go? How severe is the injury?
And that's what they're going to...
What's the return timetable?
Yeah, well, we're looking at 6 to 8 weeks before he goes under the knife. Now, there's always a chance...
It could be more, it could be less.
There's always a chance they botch the surgery. Even if the surgery goes well, there's a chance that his healing process doesn't go as planned. Blah, 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 blah.
John
Long story
Cena,
short...
be back in 2 weeks.
Yeah. But,
yeah. So anyways,
I'll kick your ass in 2 seconds. But
so long story short,
he'll probably be back by around Money in the Bank, maybe SummerSlam, they're saying. But in the chat room here, John Morgan said we could all get behind proxies and re-click all of Ryan Clark's links. That would be great.
If
you guys would click this man's links,
don't tell him.
His banners, pop-ups, buttons, his big skyscrapers—they call them those big long. The sideways rectangle ads. If you click all those fuckers, you make this man a rich guy. So, click them all. Every time you see him. Hey, it takes 2 seconds. You click it, you close it, who cares? But do it.
There you go. So, Daniel Bryan, they are not going to...
Already feels better than you.
I know. They are not going to strip him of the title. Now, that's not to say that Thursday, after he goes... After he goes under the knife and comes out of surgery, if everything goes well, like you said, could be back, gonna miss the Payback pay-per-view.
Yeah.
And that's part of the reason there was no Kane, or there was a Kane on Raw last night, but they didn't...
They killed him, just in case he's gonna be out longer than they expected. They have the explanation in the storyline.
The week
already.
Before, though, it was all Kane and Daniel Bryan, right? Blah, 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 blah.
Yeah,
so
the running,
storyline,
screaming in the car.
Right, the storyline last night was Kane dragged him out on stage.
But
and
that was done by design.
Right.
In case something goes wrong, like you're saying, we don't know exactly how long we'll be out. Just in case the worst happens.
Right.
And he's going to be out longer than expected.
They've got an angle. That's
they got video clips they can show. This is why Brian's out. Kane dragged him out. He was dead. You know.
Exactly. So we'll know more on Thursday. But right now, it looks like 6 to 8 weeks. Probably going to be back by the Money in the Bank pay-per-view. Going to miss Payback, obviously. I mean, that's a couple of weeks away.
That's
that's
no
huge.
Title match.
They were going to do a Buried Alive match at the Payback pay-per-view.
Which and I'm actually... Not I'm actually. I was actually excited
because Brian wasn't going to lose that match. I mean, they were going to kill off the Kane Monster character.
Yeah, but my point being, there's a lot of gimmick matches in WWE. Ladder matches, last man standing, whatever the fuck.
Right.
And they've beat those gimmicks to death. Like, there's no real match that hasn't been done 100,000 times.
Right.
Buried Alive's only been done a handful of times. Four, five, six times, whatever it's been.
Is that right?
It's been years since the last one.
Right.
So it was like one of those where I'm like, oh, I'm kind of excited.
Well,
this is something kind of rare.
They
buried rare in wrestling
anymore.
They buried
Paul Bearer, right? Alive.
But that was like
six
years ago.
That was a long
ago.
Time ago. You're right.
Yeah.
That was a very long time ago. But
no championship world championship match on this pay-per-view. When's the last time?
No, doesn't look like it.
When's the last time there's been a pay-per-view without a world title match?
I know.
Can't even think of one.
Yeah, so they're going to have Evolution in the Shield.
Yeah, which is the real main event.
Going to headline anyways. Yeah, well, like that's what they're basing it off. You know what I mean? I think they're going to do Cena versus Wyatt, too. They're going to... Oh, they announced that last night. Last Man Standing?
I don't know if they announced Last Man Standing. Maybe they did. I was really drunk during Raw last night. I got really drunk.
I don't think they announced it. Maybe they did on .com afterwards.
I don't know if it was .com or during Raw. I know it's official. That's the only official match so far. Or no, Shield Evolution's the only official match so far.
No, they confirmed Cena Wyatt last
night. Not officially.
Okay.
Yeah, not officially.
All right.
But it's gonna. From what we hear, it'll be Last Man Standing.
Last Man Standing match. All right, no doubt. So anyways, so we'll see what happens with Daniel Bryan. Hopefully everything goes well on Thursday. I mean, you just came in less than an hour ago when we were setting up for WZR, and you said to me, man, poor Daniel Bryan. And I put it up on Facebook.
I wrote a column about it. eWrestlingNews.com. I wrote a whole thing about it.
I put it up on Facebook last night, too. I mean, listen, the guy goes out and he gets married. One of the happiest times.
Before that, he finally gets his big moment, WrestleMania 30.
Big moment at WrestleMania.
The show ends. Yes. There's his big moment.
80,000 people. Then he gets married to the girl, his dream girl.
The next day or the day later, he marries the girl of his dreams.
It's awesome. It's great time.
Sexy Brie Bella.
Great time. Yeah. Right? She's the hotter Bella twin, by the way.
She's got the prettier face. Nikki's got the better body.
So, you know, the best time of his life, man. He finally gets a run with the WWE World Heavyweight title.
A real run.
A real run. Not just a 30-second or one-night type deal. Exactly. The next night on Raw, he loses it.
I think it was
goes out.
Somebody cashed in Money in the Bank right after he won.
It was the night after on Raw, something like that.
I thought it was actually during the show because Triple H was the ref, pedigreed him, and then the guy cashed in.
Well, there was another time that they did a celebration on the pay-per-view, and then Monday night he comes out and somebody came out and took the title. Yeah,
no, they stripped him.
They stripped him. Yeah, yeah. They stripped him, right. Because the referee the night before.
I think it was Battleground or one of those.
Who's the referee that was involved saying...
Oh, no, Scott Armstrong.
Scott Armstrong, that's what it was. So anyways, then he goes out after winning the title, his big moment. His father got to see the big moment. Goes out, gets married to the girl of his dreams.
And before we get to the
they go on a honeymoon.
Stuff. Okay.
They go on a honeymoon, man, and then he comes back from the
honeymoon. Before we get to the sad stuff, he tweets out something, which Eric Young, because TNA's completely ripping this off. Somebody made a joke. What's TNA going to do now that they don't have Daniel Bryan regularly?
Maybe Eric Young will get a neck injury.
Yeah, well, how do they copy Daniel Bryan when he's not around? Right, what are they going to do? But, well, they got everything in the can for like the next month or two anyway. Yeah. They taped a bunch of shit. But Daniel Bryan posts his tweet with these, you know, it's him and Brie putting their hands out with the wedding rings on. And he says, this is the best 2 weeks of my life.
Best 2 weeks
of my life. Very next day, his dad dies.
His father had passed away.
Man, that's bad timing.
Right when he came back from the honeymoon, right after he got married.
The day his return was going to happen on Raw, and he insisted.
Supposed to. He insisted. I guess he found out that day at Raw. Backstage at Raw. Backstage at Raw.
A couple hours before Raw, but they get to the building at like 3 or 4. What is it?
They have to be to the building by 2 p.m.
2 p.m.
They have to be at the building by 2 p.m. Yeah. Unless they call ahead of time and say, hey, I'm in traffic.
I got to do a radio interview.
Right. So that day, backstage at Raw, gets a phone call saying your father passed away.
Could you imagine?
He was a wreck, people were saying, at Raw. He came out live on Raw.
He insisted.
Right. And he insisted.
Yeah.
Like you said,
well, they said,
I need to appear.
With your family. And he's like, no, I want
to. They wanted him to go home. They wanted him to go back to Seattle and be with his family. He insisted. We've got the pay-per-view coming up. We need to do this angle.
Yeah.
Extreme Rules, we need to at least do this angle. You could see when he came out on Raw, they didn't have him talk at all that night.
They had Brie consoling him and stuff, and it was like
and
the
then
saddest
that's,
fucking thing
that's
I've
where
ever
Kane
seen.
Came out and just destroyed him, right?
The
Stephanie was,
stones,
you know,
through the table, through the steps, through the floor.
So he goes home, and he flies home to Seattle, just a wreck, and his father was only 57 years old?
I don't know.
I think 57 years old, so it wasn't, you know, it wasn't a...
No,
wasn't
it was not expected.
It wasn't like he was 80, 90 years old. It just came out of
nowhere.
It
wasn't a natural cause. It was unexpected. And we found
out... heart attack.
Okay, heart attack.
It's a heart attack.
Okay.
Well, the autopsy will come back and reveal that, but...
But that was the cause of death? I didn't even know what it was. Okay.
Heart attack.
Okay.
So, then, that same week, so you got a picture Monday... He's backstage where he gets the news that his father passed away. He doesn't appear at SmackDown the following night. I think it was Wednesday or Thursday of that same week. he finds out that the Make-A-Wish kid,
Connor McHale, or however you said it last
I want to say McGregor, but I know that's not
no,
it.
No, that's the UFC fighter.
I did it last week,
It's spelled Michael with a K, A-E-L,
They call him the Stone Crusher.
Stone Crusher. Connor McHale, Mike Yale, I don't know how you say it, but yeah. I don't know if it was his first Make-A-Wish kid, but it was one of his first, because he hasn't had that many.
Right.
It was actually his personal guest at WrestleMania 30.
Right.
And the kid dies a day or two.
Kid passed away. WWE, we haven't talked about this. WWE released a tribute video.
We talked about it either last week or the week before.
We talked about it, but the tribute video came out
now. No, we talked about the video, because I asked you about it, because I said I hadn't seen it.
You described something about it,
and you're like, dude, you got to watch it. What was the reason?
The reason where they had the kid...
Because I remember you saying, I'm like, oh, dude, I got to see that. I still haven't seen
it. The kid was backstage at a Raw taping or something like that.
Yeah.
And they had all the guys surrounding the ring.
Somebody or something.
All the guys were surrounding the ring. And Daniel Bryan and Connor are backstage.
Oh, wow.
And Daniel's music plays.
Yes.
And Connor comes out with Daniel and doing the yes, yes. Connor gets in the ring and everybody's chanting, Connor. All the superstars are around the ring. It's an empty arena.
I'm getting sad right now.
It's an empty arena. This is before, the show goes live. They're all chanting, Connor. They get in the ring and Triple H walks up and Triple H gets down on one knee and he says, come on, give me your best
Connor
shot.
Mouth pins
and Connor's like, nah, I don't want to do it. I can't hit you. And Triple H says, do it, man, do it. Connor punches him, Triple H goes down, everybody's standing, Connor, yes.
One,
doing the
two,
and then gave him the pin. They got Stephanie McMahon on the video at the end. She is in tears saying, Connor, you are,
What was he sick with? Do we know? Leukemia?
I don't want to say. Cancer or something like that. I don't know exactly what. I don't know. But God, if you go and watch that video, if you haven't seen the tribute video that WWE did,
I haven't seen.
Man, if that doesn't
what you just described, that's part of the video.
If that doesn't either melt your fucking heart, bring a tear to your eye, you ain't got a heart, man. You ain't got a heart.
What you just described, that's part of the video. You get to see.
All that stuff. Man. They have it backstage, man.
I still haven't seen it.
That shit will break your fucking heart.
From
man.
What I hear, too, it got outside attention outside of the wrestling world.
Everybody picked it up. All the media outlets. It was the top story on Yahoo.
Thanking WWE, you did a really good thing.
Yeah, it was awesome. But
back to the point, Daniel Bryan loses his dad. I mean, he wins the title.
Oh, it's terrible,
he wins
man.
The title, finally has his moment after being held down for so long. I mean, he was even fired by WWE for choking Justin Roberts, buddy, with the tie.
I forgot about that.
Yeah, he gets fired. That. Well, they had this... My Journey to WrestleMania or something documentary on him.
Right. Yeah.
WWE Network. I watched it. It was fucking excellent.
Yep.
Half kayfabe, half shoot, but it was really cool. But they explain in that video. And they even show it. Like him choking Justin Roberts with his tie and they say he got fired.
Right.
But alright, so he goes through all this stuff. He's held down forever. Like the last 4 months of 2013, they're fucking shitting on him, burying him. Cena's on the shelf with his elbow or whatever, and everybody's saying, yo, Daniel Bryan's our guy. They keep holding him down. Randy Orton faces WWE, and they hold him down. Finally, he has his big moment at WrestleMania. Beats Triple H. Wins the main event. Wins the fucking undisputed championship. The show goes off the air. Yes. Is it really?
Is the net in there?
No, it's not.
Is it lit up?
Yeah.
Is it? All right.
Shouldn't be.
We should be okay. We'll see how it goes. Go ahead. Keep going.
But
it's the best time of his life, man.
Yes, he wins the title, has his big moment, show goes off the air, everybody, he's got his big moment. Then he goes and marries the girl of his dreams, the sexy fucking Brie Bella.
She is hot, man.
She's so fucking hot. I watch Total Divas. She's so goddamn hot, and she seems really cool, too. But, alright, so he gets his title, he gets his moment, he gets his girl, he marries her, they're on their honeymoon, he tweets, best 2 weeks of my life.
Yep.
Next day, dad dies. Connor, the Stone
that
Crusher,
week,
dies.
Connor dies. Now he's got
Batista
a neck injury.
Batista refuses to work with him and job to him, so he's got to work with Kane in this shit match that's like third under John Cena, Bray Wyatt, and Shield Evolution. I mean, it went on last, but it seemed like the third most important match. Then Batista refused to work for him, so it's going to be Kane and Daniel Bryan again, and it's like his title reign is not going as good as you would think. And then...
Good to go.
Broken neck. His fucking neck's broken. He's going to get surgery. He's going to be on the shelf even longer. The steam is getting worn off.
Right.
His title run, it's not this big fucking crescendo we've been building to, this big moment. No, it's the exact opposite. It's like, yo, he's here some weeks, he's not. There's no like, yo, Brian's fucking doing this right now. Instead, it's, you know, boom, boom.
And you know
boom,
what? How is boom. WWE? You know how WWE, I mean, there are people in WWE that feel Daniel Bryan should be pushed to the moon. There are other people that want to hold this guy back, and you've seen it in recent months.
So
and now an injury. And yeah. now a neck injury.
Now they got every excuse in the world.
They've got every excuse in the world to get the title off him. He's got a neck injury. Is he ever going to be the same when he wrestles? This, that, and the other thing. And there's
no more flying headbutts, most likely.
Right. There's going to be people in the company saying, you know, we've got to get the title off. We can't take a risk like this. Hopefully everything goes well on Thursday with the surgery.
Absolutely.
Hey. Let's, by the way, for those that have tuned in late, I know the chat room, WZROnline.com/chat, there's a problem. Only the stream is loading over there. The chat room's not loading. We installed some new security on WZROnline.com. So, you can go to my Facebook page or Matt Boone's Facebook page, Facebook.com/@MattBooneWZR or Facebook.com/@RyanClarkWZR. You can go there. On my page, it's the third post down. There's two posts on top.
On mine, it's the first.
There you go.
It's the second.
Well, there you go. Sorry. Go to one of our pages, right. And there's a chat room post. We've directly linked it. It'll say something like client16.addonchat.com or
something like that.
You guys can... You can go there, you can click that link, and it's the same chat room that you're normally used to every week. Yeah. So check it out, Facebook.com/MattBooneWZR, Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. All right, let's get into it, man. Monday Night Raw. We got about 20 minutes. We've already talked about some of the stuff with Daniel Bryan and Kane.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, we have.
Oh, dragging them out.
Dragging them out. So, once again, The Shield, the last couple of weeks, man, it's been The Shield show on
and
Monday
the Evolution
Raw.
Show.
And the Evolution show, right?
And Bray Wyatt.
Bray Wyatt as well, no doubt.
No John Cena, though, 2 weeks in a row.
Yeah, I know. And you know what? They used...
Fuck me, man. If I just got the hiccups, the show
You got
ruined.
The hiccups?
Because when I get
You got
them,
the hiccups?
When I get them, they last for like an hour.
Do they?
Yeah.
Deep breaths. Take deep...
Doesn't work. Hold Fuck, them, I think I got them. Them.
Yeah.
Shit!
Oh, man. Right. That's not a good time.
I'll carry us.
All right, so... Monday Night Raw opens up, right, and the Shield is already in the ring, right. So they're not about to run from Evolution, right?
No,
they
never.
Are standing here tonight. They're standing
tall. They're the
babyface. Dean Ambrose starts out on the microphone. Seth Rollins follows up.
This is how he talks, man.
Yeah.
Awesome. He's got a voice like this.
He's awesome, man.
Triple H is, you know.
Whatever. He's awesome. How about Roman Reigns on the microphone?
Yo,
we haven't heard much from Roman Reigns, right? We've heard bits and pieces and backstage segments, but
they give him the nice punch at the end. That last one-liner that
they always
keep it short.
We haven't heard him really talk.
Last
a couple
night he
of
talked.
Sentences. Last night he talked.
Hey, can I tell you something?
Yo, he's gonna be a star. I always thought. I knew
the
that he
motherfucker's got it, bro.
I knew that he had the
look. Whole thing.
I knew that he had the look.
The look.
And I knew that he's all right in ring.
No,
he
started off all right. He's been getting not only good, but
much
great in
that
the
spear,
ring.
He's perfected that spear.
That kick on the ground where he hopped up to the apron.
Yep.
The Superman punch.
Yep.
He's triple powerbomb. He's got all kinds of cool shit.
He's perfected. And the crowd pops with the spear. They pop huge with the Superman pump.
The kick to the apron where he lands
punch,
his ass.
They pop huge.
Yeah.
So last night, the only thing I was worried about is Roman Reigns on the microphone.
Yeah.
I'm thinking, I don't
Absolutely.
Know.
Absolutely.
Last night, we heard him talk. Boom.
And I got news for you, too.
I'm telling you.
This isn't about Roman Reigns, but it's about the Shield.
Right.
Everybody thinks Dean Ambrose is the best talker in the group. Can I tell you something?
I wouldn't go that.
Can I tell you something?
I wouldn't go that.
I'm not talking about Roman Reigns.
Seth Rollins?
Seth Rollins
has
been killing it.
He's good.
He's been killing it on the microphone.
And I said,
killing it.
I said, Seth Rollins has that lisp.
Rollins.
I say Rollins.
Doesn't he have a lisp?
He's got a lisp. You've
never
noticed,
that.
Man.
No.
He's got
not
a
like
lisp.
Swagger, you know, swagger.
No. And I've always said that I think that lisp is gonna hold him down, and it hasn't. It hasn't because
I've never
to be honest
noticed.
With you, As far as mic work is concerned, the Shield and mic work. The Shield and mic work is concerned. Seth Rollins is number one. Or as far as who's been talking the most in recent weeks, Seth Rollins is number one.
He gets the longest.
Dean Ambrose is number two, and Roman Reigns number three. He gets the longest.
Well, it's funny when it started off this group, and you can go back and look at
Ambrose was,
he wrote.
Was the
you
star,
can look at reports.
Yeah.
You can watch archives of this show. Ambrose was the leader, we would call him, of the Shield.
Right.
Rollins was the workhorse. Reigns was the big fucking jacked up.
Just the beast.
Guy that they like to look
the
up.
The enforcer, you know.
As things have evolved, I say Ambrose would be the bottom of the list now. I'd say
Ambrose
Rollins,
is the bottom, right.
Rollins is the best worker in the ring. I would lay the claim, and I know there's people who would argue it, he's the best talker. I'd say the last two, maybe three weeks.
I think
weeks,
Ambrose is the best talker still.
I'd say the last two or three weeks. I'd say Ambrose has the most...
he's got that voice.
He's got the most effective personality.
Right.
But
right.
The guy who's been cutting the best promos? Rollins. I'm sorry, guys.
He's also been given the most mic time out of all of them.
Yeah.
But
you get your chance at the plate, you know. And you know, some guys have double the left, some guys,
all three of them. Each one of them, they've got their own. I think Roman Reigns has got the whole fucking package.
He does.
He's got the look.
And he's
we
got
heard
the guys behind him. The important guys in the company behind him. That's
like
more important than any talent or ability
he
might have.
He's a young guy.
Young,
he's going to be around for
years.
Related
to The Rock and all those guys.
Roman Reigns is going to be... And the only thing that I question...
That's the biggest thing against Rollins is his size.
Right.
Ambrose, too, to an extent.
The only thing that I questioned about Roman Reigns was, can this dude talk on the microphone? Can this dude be good on the microphone?
Yeah.
And what we saw last night, we didn't see a lot from Roman Reigns, but we saw enough.
Last night.
We saw more than usual. We saw enough to know that, you know what?
And
this dude can cut a promo. He's got the look. He's going to be a megastar, man.
Absolutely.
He's going to be a megastar.
Normally, they save, Rollins starts or Ambrose starts. Rollins continues or Ambrose continues. And then here's the last big fucking, they get a cute little line that's unique and cool.
Right.
And Reigns does it with like a monotone, scary voice. You know what I mean? Like, like real passion. But last night they actually let him talk for a good minute.
Mm.
And I think he really delivered. I really think he came through.
Is the light on? Just check one more time for me, man. All right.
Are they saying it again?
Well, they said it's skipping a little bit. If the stream is skipping,
come on, man.
Just let us know in the live chat room, guys. I don't believe it's on our end.
I'm having fun. Why is it gotta be?
No, we're good. We're gonna have the archive. The archive will be up as well, without the skipping, without any issues. But just keep us posted in the chat room if it gets worse and worse and worse. Let us know if it gets better,
It won't be up with us. If we're skipping on the air right now, then
no, we're good to go. You've got the archive, and it never skips.
Yeah, it records whatever we're doing right now.
It records whatever we're doing, correct, on the actual file, so it doesn't skip.
If it's Ustream that's making a skip, then
the
archive will be fine.
That's
if it's us that's making a skip, that's going to be part of the archive.
I've been viewing the log there. We're
it's
not skipping.
Fine.
We're not skipping. So it's Ustream.
So it's got to be Ustream,
right?
That's
the internet.
Okay.
But let us know, guys.
Fine. And I trust someone's Lair. One of Lair knows what he's saying. Yeah.
All right, no doubt. So anyways, so let's get back into it. So the Shield cuts this promo on Raw. All three
very
were
good.
What was that last one?
Stream
is all right, no doubt.
Fine,
maybe it's just your internet, I don't know. We're good.
Maybe it was one person. His own computer.
So what? We had Evolution pulls up in a limo.
Yes.
And they get out, and that's pretty much it. Or Evolution runs to the back. Or the
Shield
runs
to the
back.
And Triple H is signing something on a clipboard, and then bam, Evolution.
Doing the signing.
The Shield ambushes.
If you guys have ever been backstage, when the talents pull in to the arena, there's a checklist, right?
Do they really have to sign in like a
and
doctor's
they've got
office?
To sign in like a doctor's office. You've arrived. If you're on the list.
Like school, they take attendance.
It.
It's Marty Jones
it's
here. Here.
That's what it is.
Yeah, okay.
It's attendance. They pull in and they check your name off and you've got to sign
that
you're here. So anyways, so that's what happened. And it's funny, Triple H of all people, the COO of WWE has to sign in.
It's not really the COO,
Triple H.
By the way.
What's his role?
It's not his real title.
Triple H's real title. Stephanie McMahon is the... So, Stephanie McMahon doesn't have anything to do with creative these
not
days.
Nothing. She's, but she doesn't...
Very head, little.
She used to head creative.
What is Triple H's role in the company,
He handles talent.
I could have sworn there was a press release. There was a press release that said Triple H had been promoted.
He's not the COO.
Chief Operating Officer is COO.
I mean, he's got those duties, but I don't think that's his title.
He's got a title. He's got
He does have a title.
Okay.
And he's way up.
But it's not the COO.
But I don't think it's COO.
That's a storyline.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I think so.
All right. Okay.
I think so.
I'll take your word for it.
Okay.
But anyways, we had... So yeah, they go back in attack.
Yeah, yeah. And then we move on to the next thing.
Jack Swagger and Rob Van Dam.
Uh-huh.
How... When Rob Van Dam...
Well, we come back in the ring. Zip Coulter's standing over... Swagger's holding a deportation list sign.
Swagger.
And Zip Coulter reveals that he has added Adam Rose to his deportation list. Setting up Swagger Rose.
I love a deportation list.
Yeah,
come
too.
On, that's funny,
it's
man.
Great. Coulter's the man.
When Rob Van Dam's music hits, when it's like, right?
And then I have it.
And then he comes out. Do you have it? Throw it up. When RVD's music hits, dude, doesn't it? It has that feel.
That's one feel to it.
It's just gotta feel like BAM! What the
guy?
Yeah, it's gotta. I don't know, when he comes out.
I gotta tell you though, I don't think I have that. I'll check real quick.
Oh. What are you playing, Adam Roses? Right here.
Oh. His EC dub thing.
Pantera,
nothing
baby.
Touches that.
That's
bro.
Pantera.
I don't even fucking like heavy metal.
Three!
Like that kind of
smack.
Shit.
What you say?
That's a badass song.
It's awesome.
And the whole ECW crowd, Bree! And they would all, SPANG!
Ah, dude.
Wrong!
Who's got
what do you say?
Who's got the best entrance in the history?
I don't have
of
the same
ECW.
Answer.
Ah,
I don't have it. I don't, wait, maybe I do. Yes,
dude.
I do.
Yes!
It's a slow start.
Yeah, it's
listen.
A slow start. Yeah.
Skip ahead?
Yeah. Here it comes.
Sandman.
Ready?
That's where he was cracking the beer, right?
Yeah, man. That was
this
awesome.
Fucking guy was such a Sandman, Mark. He used to take the beer can, and I'm telling you something, ladies and gentlemen, it hurts. I've done it. It fucking hurts. And he would do it until he bleeds and everything. And I'm like, yo, you're a sick fucking asshole. And he'd
Back.
I'd have blood. Yeah, he would fucking chug it, and he'd go, bop, 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 bop.
You know what
like,
got me?
He'd be like, yo, am I bleeding? I'm like, no.
No.
Bop, bop, bop. You got me. I'm like, dude, what the fuck? It's a rusty
it's that little
can.
Fucking cap right there. That
yeah.
little thing on it, dude. Whack, whack, whack.
That would get me.
Yeah. But anyways, Sandman was awesome, and he's
he was, yeah.
All right, so anyway,
well, that entrance was awesome.
So the deportation list, right? He's added Adam Rose, and of
setting
course...
Setting up Swagger Rose for payback.
Setting up Swagger Rose
yeah,
for payback.
Yeah, which would be Rose's in-ring debut for the main roster.
Now, of course, Adam Rose's music hits. He
yeah, that was kind of weird. They didn't even really do a match. The bell rang to make the match official.
Yeah.
But as soon as it rang, and I've got his theme...
A little tweak to his entrance theme last night. What
was there?
Yeah. Right
oh, like
before.
A little more of an intro or something,
yeah,
right?
It was something before, though. Oh.
Let's hear if it's on here.
That's it.
That's it?
That's it.
So they played the whole thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wait for it.
Oh, whoops. I played the wrong one.
There was a little thing.
Oh, it skips ahead. Shit. I must have
it was
it
a little thing.
From the wrong place.
Like, whatever just played in Sheamus's, the opening theme,
yeah.
the opening thing there, it was like a damn. Oh. You know?
Yeah,
something like that.
If you give me, all right, I got it. I got it right now. Here we go. Hold on, I haven't hit it yet.
Here I'm here. No, there was something before that.
Right there.
That went on longer.
Did
whatever
it?
That was
okay,
went
well,
on
that's
longer.
That's what it was.
Yeah.
Anyways, during the RVD Swagger match, right when the bell rings, maybe a few seconds in, before
hey,
they even
hey,
did
hey,
anything,
hey.
Yeah, this music hits, out comes the big fucking bunny. And,
yeah.
One
the
bunny's guys,
over. The
one
bunny's
of the guys,
over.
One of the guys was who?
It was NXT. It was
yeah.
Rebecca Lynch, Sasha Banks.
Guy.
NXT producer. It was Simon Gotch, who is an NXT producer. It was Rebecca Lynch. It was Sasha Banks. I don't know.
A bunch of NXT.
Right.
All
a bunch. And a bunch of NXT.
I wonder who wears the bunny.
Whoa.
I wonder who wears that bunny.
I don't know. But the bunny's over. The money's over, right?
I think the song's over more than anything.
What
the fans like to go, whoa. Did we find out, did WWE produce this song, or is this the main theme song that they bought the rights to?
I think I've heard this before.
Me too.
I think I've heard this.
Me too.
Yeah. I've definitely heard this. So we had so Adam Rose comes out, right, and he does the whole, what do you think of Adam Rose? I think, and we put it up on the website, Adam Rose is kind of a failure so far.
Really?
In what sense? In the sense that the crowd hasn't reacted. Last night they were worse than what they were in Albany.
They weren't bad in Albany.
Did you see
the reports
last night
coming out of the building said it wasn't that great?
Okay.
You know what? I take that back. There were conflicting reports coming out of the Pepsi Center?
Times Union Center.
There were conflicting reports. Some said that, he was monstrously over, and everybody's singing, whoa. And then it was other people like, it wasn't that over. I listen on TV, and that's all I have is audio, because I'm right here with play-by-play, and I glance every once in a while. So I depend a lot on hearing.
What the fuck is this? I'm sorry. where does that come from?
I don't know.
I go to a bar or I go to a club and I get in a lot of fights. I don't like that fight.
I mean, I know it's not really Buff Bagwell, but I've gotten into a fight with that guy before. Not physically.
I'm a nice drunk, to be honest. You're a very nice drunk.
He's a fun drunk. Yeah. I'm the asshole drunk.
I slap
bouncers, get kicked out of bars and banned.
I'm fun. I'd be the guy telling him, chill out,
yes,
man. Chill out. I'm fun.
There's a time where
I fight.
Pick my blah, blah, and then you would have to restrain me. Because I wanted to go kill that motherfucker, and you're holding me down, and I'm drunk enough that you're able to do that. Because if I'm sober, I'll throw his ass off like a fucking leaf or something. But, if you remember, there was one time we went out on the strip in Albany. Actually, you didn't come with us. Your sister did, though.
Yeah.
It was me, Steve, and your sister, Liz,
that whole crew,
whatever,
right?
The rest of them were. And I got us kicked out of each fucking five.
I wouldn't doubt it.
Five
you're an
different
asshole.
Bars. She could
you're
tell
an
the
asshole.
Story. She could tell the story. Five different bars in a row.
Hey.
Boom. And there's at one point where like I'm just walking around Albany and they don't know where I am because I got kicked out. They're at the table and chilling or whatever.
You're stumbling
all over
the place.
I get kicked out. They don't even know I'm gone. And then eventually they realize and they're like, oh shit, we got to find Boone. He's drunk running around Albany somewhere. And they had to find me and stuff. But yeah.
Nah, you're crazy. You are fucking crazy.
I didn't have a way home, so I had to take a cab. I took a cab yesterday. I see this guy sitting on a stoop because everybody in New York sits on the stoop. With the beers and the stoop and everything. We did that at Dove Street a lot. But I see these two people sitting on the stoop, and I say, I see you got a cell phone. Can I use your cell phone? They let me use the cell phone. I call a cab, and the cab picks me up. The thing is, I don't have any money. I done spend it all at the bar, so I got no money. I call the cab. Cab takes me to that, we were in East Greenbush at this point. It takes me back to our apartment. I have to go in the room.
I remember this night. It's about five in the morning.
5 in the morning. I got to wake them up. Because the last call in New York is 4 a.m.
It is.
In most places, it's 2. Like, Florida was 2 a.m. In New York, it's 4 a.m. Those extra 2 hours kill me.
Yeah.
That's when all the kickouts happen for me.
Right.
I have to wake them up. I say, dude, I just took a cab here.
I'm not happy.
I said, dude, I don't have any money. I got to pay this cab driver. He said, here's a 20. Get the fuck out of my room. I'm sleeping.
Fuck out of here. It's 5 in the morning. Go to bed. It's 5 in the morning. Go to fucking bed.
No, he's a fun drunk. God, asshole.
Anyway, so we had, so Adam Rose comes out, right, and they do the whole thing. It was Swagger. It was basically the setup.
Swagger,
Rob Van Dam hits a...
It's a kick, 5-star Fox Splash, 1, 2, 3,
bang, bang, bang.
That's the whole thing.
Alicia Fox against Paige. Listen,
did you catch this promo that we're talking about?
Alicia Fox cut up... No, that was Sandow in the pre-show.
No, on the app,
this
quit.
Is after the... Oh, she quit after the segment.
Was it after? Yeah,
it was
I
after.
Didn't say when it was, but yeah.
So Alicia Fox, I'm telling
did
you,
catch
I think...
Sandow promo?
I didn't catch it, but I heard
either.
About
I'm
it.
Looking for it, too.
Alicia Fox is one of the best divas on the rosters. On the roster.
She's hot
she's
as shit.
She's athletic.
She's
every
a
time,
fucking light-skinned black chick with
she knows how to
blue
sell.
Eyes.
She knows
crazy
how,
hot.
She knows how to sell.
Yeah.
She I
and
just,
all that stuff,
I, th-
whatever,
I think Alicia
hot.
Fox, yeah. Alicia Fox is one of the best divas on the roster.
She is
and
the
I'm happy
of WWE.
I can see that. Mulatto, light skin.
Mulatto's racist these days, by the way.
Oh, Mulatto.
Yeah, you can't say Mulatto.
So,
you gotta
people
say,
yelling at me for saying midget the other day.
That's bad, too. You gotta say little person.
There, if you, if
little
you
person's
Google,
midget, and you don't say Mulatto, you say, what is it, mixed?
If you go to...
Interracial.
I want you to do this. Go to Google, and you Google
you
midget...
Go
you go to... You,
stream
you,
up.
All right. I'm telling the people in the chat.
Oh,
right.
Oh,
you
sorry.
Google midget wrestling. There are, like, 10 different promotions... titled Midget Wrestling Southwest.
Yeah.
Midget Entertainment. All these
in wrestling midget's an accepted term.
I guess
in
so.
In regular pop culture, you don't say midget. It's
I got like yelled at. A lot of people.
It's very bad.
A lot of people.
I didn't call it.
A lot of people yelled at me for using the word midget
it's
on,
like
on the website.
Like saying pike for a Jew or dago for an Italian.
I don't know. Just seemed to me like a midget. I don't know. I wasn't trying to offend anybody.
Midget wrestling, that's an accepted term in wrestling.
Alicia Fox and Paige, what do you... How about the way, you know, they build Paige up that she gets destroyed and
it's
every
like the
match,
old Ric Flair thing. She gets her
combat.
Ass kicked the whole match, somehow finds a way
somehow comes back.
She doesn't do the heel spin where on her promo she acts like, yo, I kicked her ass and blah, 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 blah.
Now, Alicia Fox, after the match, right? Uh-huh. She throws a fit. She goes over
this
to the commentary.
This WWE... Fucking with
I think WWE was ribbing the announcers here. Where JBL had a reaction on his face.
They didn't know it was coming.
What the fuck is going on? It was clearly a rib on the announcers. I'm glad you agree with that.
She doesn't have enough balls to do it on her own. So clearly she was working based on orders. And if you just look at the reaction of the announcers,
look
they
at the
didn't
reaction
know.
Of the announcers. Or
they
have no
fucking
idea.
Best Oscar-worthy announcers of all time. And they're not.
They didn't know.
You know. Watch Michael Cole try and put something over. It's funny, and you can tell he's not a good actor.
Right.
You know, like, you know when he's trying to laugh at something.
It's
they didn't know it was coming. Fox was fucking with him per orders.
Fox took off
it was
JBL's
Vince
hat.
Having fun.
And not only that, but you know,
it was Vince having fun.
Alicia walked away with JBL's hat on.
Yeah.
And JBL didn't even go after her or nothing because he doesn't want to do the wrong thing.
Her,
if he doesn't, well, take his hat back or something like that.
Yeah. Because
if he does the wrong thing,
or have that confused
automatically.
Like, what the fuck? He was playing into it. Like whoa.
He don't want to get in trouble.
Yeah,
if he does the wrong thing, if he does something Vince doesn't want him to do, like take the hat back or something like that.
Well, he's
gonna
get
in trouble,
trouble
and
but
he's gonna get heat and everything else.
Not so much trouble or heat. It would be more of a situation where you get made fun of. Like, oh, you can't improvise.
Right.
You can't roll with the punches, JBL.
Exactly.
You're a 20-year veteran.
Exactly.
You don't know how to roll.
Exactly. If you're listen, I said midgets. If you're really offended, listen. It's
nobody's
little,
offended
it's,
by that.
It's
people
little
pretend.
People. Maybe I should have called them little people, but midgets. I'm not. It's not a racist term in my opinion.
It's not.
Midget.
Well, first of all, it's not a race. There's no such thing as a race of midgets.
Well, whatever. What would you call it? A
bias or something?
Bias,
or prejudice.
I don't. Prejudice. That's.
But
all right.
Yeah. No. There's a lot of people, and you say if you're offended by it, there's a lot of people that think I'm supposed to. Be offended by this, so let me pretend like I'm offended.
Right.
9 times out of 10, those motherfuckers are full of shit. They're not personally offended.
They want to be
midget.
Politically correct.
They
want to
have
so
everybody
people.
Comment on a little dickhead internet thing and say, you're right. They
There's
should have
so
said
many
midget. How
wanna,
dare they say midget?
They want to be politically
Nobody
correct.
Cares.
You know what? Joan Rivers came out and she trashed.
Nobody cares.
Joan Rivers
Nobody
came
else.
Out and she trashed the people, the three girls that were held up in the house for like 10 years.
I don't know what you're talking about.
But anyways, and everybody said, I can't believe she did that. Joan Rivers is the only one, and I give her all the credit in the world.
She's
People
very
come out
honest.
And they say all this stuff, right? And what they say, it's what they're really thinking. And then the media says, you need to apologize. Joan Rivers came out and said, I'm a fucking comedian. Fuck you. I'm not apologizing. If you don't like it, too fucking bad. And if I get thrown off, television shows, if I get thrown off the network that I'm on, too bad. I made a joke. If you don't like it, grow a fucking sense of... And granted, the joke that she made, it was brutal. It was brutal.
That's her
But
style.
That's her gig. That's her gig.
That's
her
gimmick.
She did it. So, and all these people that say stuff, and then they're pressured to come out. You have to apologize. And then they come out with these statements. I
you
sincerely
lose sponsors.
Apologize.
You lose,
oh, I sincerely apologize.
And it's phony.
The reason they do it is because they don't want to lose sponsors.
But
and they
David
don't want to
Daniel
lose.
Sterling. What's his name?
David
Daniel
Sterling.
Sterling?
David Sterling.
David or Daniel?
David Sterling. He came out. God, he did an interview with Anderson.
Funniest fucking apology you've ever seen.
He didn't apologize. He said Magic Johnson had AIDS.
Oh,
he
I'm said, thinking of Don Imus. Remember nappy-headed hoes?
Don Imus, right.
Yeah.
Yo,
Al Sharpton says you need to apologize. Who the fuck? What
Sterling
does Al
came
Sharpton
out,
have to do with anything?
Sterling came out in an interview last night and he says, Magic Johnson, you know, people look up
to
this guy.
Yeah, what has he done?
People look up to this guy. He's got AIDS. He went from city to city.
Yeah.
First of all, Donald, or it's Donald Sterling. First of all, Donald.
Is it Donald?
Donald. Donald Sterling.
It was Daniel or David. Okay.
So,
Donald Sterling.
First
that
of all,
right.
Magic didn't have AIDS. He was HIV positive.
Yes.
Big difference between
there
HIV.
There is a big difference. A lot of people don't know that.
So anyway, so He dug himself a deeper hole last night by doing...
He should shut up.
He should shut his mouth, man.
He should shut up. Anyway, I will disagree with you on this, and we had a
Buff
big argument.
Buff on the chat room. No, I don't.
We had a big argument. What'd Buff say?
Who knows? We gotta go to break. Let's come back from the break.
Do you hate midgets? No, we had a big argument one day when the punishment for Sterling came in. I agreed with the fact that, what was he, fired or suspended?
Who?
Sterling.
Right now he's suspended, and they're trying to out him as an owner.
I said, that's great. The company has this policy. They disagree with what he said. They suspend him. Fine.
Okay.
But they also fined him like $2 million, $3 million.
They should have.
Huh?
That's pocket.
They'll save the discussion for an hour or two.
The guy's a billionaire.
I don't care if it's a lot. If it's not a lot of money to him.
You find the guy $2 million. That's pocket change.
Listen, was he an asshole?
$2 million.
Was he an asshole? Was he racist?
Yeah.
Did he violate policy? Yes. Should he be suspended? Is he a fucking dick? Should the public think he's a scumbag? Yes.
Well, then they're gonna do all that. Why not fine him?
You can't take $2 million away for somebody speaking their opinion. As much as I disagree with it and think he's a racist prick,
he's not.
You don't take millions of dollars from him for speaking his mind.
To him,
doesn't matter.
He's a public figure.
Doesn't matter.
He's not your average Joe. He's a public figure. He's the owner of an NBA team.
So you suspend him.
You suspend him and
take millions of his money.
If you're going to suspend him, he should be fined as well. That's normally what happens. They get fined and they get suspended. Fuck out of here. You're listening to WZR TV.
Yeah. You're watching us.
Fucking Herb right here, yeah. Matt Boone.
You want to give me a chop back? You owe me like two. Go ahead.
Can I? Really?
Go ahead. Come on, don't fucking load up on it. Just do it. All right. With who?
With Matt Boone and Ryan Clark.
Go ahead.
We'll be back right after this.
Yeah.
Woo!
Man, we got him now.
We ain't stopping. Shit.
Started from the bottom.
Go.
We all up now. Started from the bottom. We're here. WZR TV. It's Tuesday night. 9 o'clock, which means we're in our dose, which means we're taking your phone calls. You can start calling us whenever you feel like it at 518-712-3070. I don't know if he put rapid fire up, but if he did, that would be at facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. I said that's facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR, about to be joined by the host of this shindig himself. Looks like he's killing time because he thinks I can't do this by myself. He could fucking sit in his room all night long for all I care. All I need is a camera, a microphone, and an audience. I'm a rock and roll legend. This ain't my first rodeo, folks. Hate to break it to you. Whenever he gets his punk bitch ass back in here, we'll pick up where we left off with last night's Monday Night Raw. We will look ahead to the WWE Payback pay-per-view. I hope we have time to discuss the UFC from this past Saturday night. And whatever else we've got on the store. Did you put the rapid fire up?
What's up there, buddy?
What's up? Did you put rapid fire up?
Talking some shit. Talking some shit.
Oh.
I heard you talking a little shit in here.
What'd you hear?
I was taking a pee. And I heard you.
I don't know what you consider shit talking. What is that?
Something about the show hits the road. Should have peed during
the
break.
Yeah, yeah.
If we go to McDonald's and we're on the road.
We're not pulling over.
Yes, I put the rapid fire up.
All right. Well, then they can submit their questions and comments.
Tell them we're back.
I told them we're back.
Hour number two.
I told them all we need is
my
a camera.
Phone calls.
We need a camera, a microphone, and an audience, and I'm fucking good to go. This ain't my first rodeo. I don't need you sitting next to me to do this. Be quite honest with you. Sit here by myself and entertain the masses. No fucking problem. Take a hike. The fuck?
You get the fuck out of here.
This is my room. I can't. Where am I going to go?
The fuck out of here. I'll throw you right on the fucking street. Right. So, here we are.
Here we are.
We need to finish up Monday Night Raw.
Yes.
From last night. Live chat room. It's going to be the fourth post down on my Facebook page or the second post down on Matty Boone's Facebook. Facebook.com/MattBooneWZR. Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. Check it out. You can get to our live chat room. You're going to see a link. It's like client16.addonchat.com or something like that. Click that link and you guys can get into our live chat room tonight. How's the chest feel? It wasn't a very good one, was it?
I forgot that you did.
Yeah,
you
said that. Kind of a weak one.
Pretty much a pussy, so don't worry about it.
Anyways.
Actually, no, it was a good one. It hurt for a second.
Uh-huh.
When it first happened.
Yeah.
But I'm a grown man and the chop wears off in 2 seconds.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Anyways, so let's get back into it. Here we go. Monday Night Raw. Adam Rose and Alicia Fox and Paige talked about that. Daniel Bryan, this is where he comes out, announces that he is going to...
We were arguing before the break about Donald Sterling.
Donald Sterling.
Yeah, that's what we left off on. And I still say you shouldn't have taken this. I mean, all right, fine him.
I don't think she should have been fined.
You don't think?
No. I think he should have been fined.
I don't think he should have been fined.
Yeah.
Now, if you want to fine him, okay. Millions of dollars for speaking your mind. It's not against the law to hate fucking somebody.
That's chump change to him,
I don't
bro.
Care. That, you're focusing on the fact that he's rich and, it's not going to affect him. I don't care what it affects him like.
Or would you fine him less just because?
Whatever the company policy is. If a guy fucking breaks a rule, you can fine $10,000. Or whatever. $2 million just because he's got billion. That's fucked up. That is fucked
if you're
up.
If you're in a position of power, and you own a team that employs African Americans, Chris Paul, and there's a lot of black.
The whole fucking team, yeah.
There's Blake Griffin's on there. There's a couple white guys.
He's kind of he's a mulatto, as you would call him, isn't he?
Right. But I think the fact is he's he comes out and he says, "Well, I put food on these guys' table, and I do this, that, and the other thing." He does. Okay. He does. I mean,
what was the offensive thing he said? I don't even know.
V. Stiviano's the mistress, right? The whole thing that people are forgetting is Donald Sterling, this is a married man. But the wife came out and said that they've been estranged for a while now and she was going to file a divorce. She had the divorce papers and she was ready to sign them.
Okay.
But her people said, no, why don't you wait a little bit? Why? Clearly, there's a lot
grab.
Of money.
Yeah.
It's a money grab. Don't divorce them because if you stay with them, you've got the prenup and everything else, obviously. So, but anyway, this V. Stiviano was, she is
you gotta
she's
tell
the
me.
One. She was trying to bait him. And if you listen to the
what
audio recordings, she was trying to bait.
No. What was his comment that he made?
He was upset that V. Stiviano went out and took a photo with Magic Johnson.
Oh.
She put the photo of herself and Magic up on Instagram.
Okay.
He didn't want a photo of her with Magic Johnson to be up on Instagram. He didn't think that she should advertise that to the world. And she said,
advertise what?
She baited him into it. She said, well, why not? Why can't I put that photo up? He said,
take a picture with a celebrity, you put it on your Facebook.
Black.
Of course.
He's black.
That's
Magic
why?
He's black. If she and he came out on the audio recording, basically said, well, if it's a white guy.
Put it on tape?
Well,
if it's
a white guy, it's fine. She can go and she can do whatever. But Sterling doesn't want photos with her and black guys to be posted on the Instagram. Why does she have to go out and advertise?
What's
to the
her
world?
Name again?
V. Stiviano, and there's Vivica, she's used different aliases.
No. Her nationality is she like?
Oh.
What is she like?
That's the thing.
She's not American, right?
She is part black. She's like mulatto. So, in the recording,
you can't
she says,
mulatto. I'm telling
she
you,
says,
that's racist.
She says to him, she says, well, what's the problem with me? Look at me. I'm Caucasian or whatever
she's
it is.
Super hot because he's rich.
She's pretty hot.
Okay.
She kind of looks like a man, to be honest. She's got that face.
You seen them pictures of Bo Dallas and Bray Wyatt's sister? Mika Rotundo?
I know they're dating, right? They are dating, right?
Who's dating?
Bo Dallas and I read something about
sister.
That. Bray's sister.
Bray and Bo are brothers.
Oh.
They're both kids of Earl R. Scheisser, IRS, Mike Rotundo.
Who's dating who?
Or Barry Windham, I forget. But, no.
Charlotte. That's the one.
Charlotte
was dating.
No,
she's dating
some jobber that just got fired from it. Kenneth.
That's who it was. The NXT guy that got fired
Bram,
was dating Charlotte.
The TNA guy, Bram.
That's who it brand.
Yeah.
That's who it is.
But no. They,
so anyways,
my boss Shalik put up pictures of Mika Rotunda.
Okay.
And it's Bray Wyatt and Bo Dallas, their brothers.
Their sister. Their sister. Okay.
And it's one of those where it's funny because Shalik brought up a point that made me laugh. I'm saying she's kind of fucking smoking hot. Who would have thought? And he's like, she looks like a female version of Bo Dallas, and she does.
Does she?
A very similar face, but like a girl version of his face.
Right.
And I'm talking to him, and I'm like, that's kind of like Ryan and his sister, bro. I'm like, every once in a while, Every once in a while, I'll look at
I
your
don't
sister.
Look like Allison.
Every once in a while, I'll look at your sister, and I'll be like, she's kind of hot. Every once in a while. And then I'll remind myself by looking at her, it's basically a female version of Ryan Clark. It's the same face, only the girl version. So it freaks me out, and I'm like, no, she's not hot. But then you look at her body, where there's no fucking face attached, and you're like, eh, not bad. But then you see the face, and it's like, yo, that's a girl Ryan Clark right there. What the fuck? And that's what the Bo Dallas Mika Rotunda thing is. She has Bo Dallas's face with a girl touch to it. And then,
yeah.
and then a smoking body. So you, at first glance, you're like, damn, she's hot. And then you look at her face a little bit, and you're like, oh, whoa, whoa. That's like Bo Dallas with long hair. Or like, I guess he's got
a lot of hair. A lot of people look like that, family.
But have you ever known that before, where you're friends with a guy,
right,
and
right.
a friend, and his sister is like a girl version of him?
I got a friend, Jeremy. He put a photo of his sister the other day, and I
and every
said,
once in a while,
wow, they look identical.
No, not that. Obviously, Jeremy. Brothers and sisters look alike. Have you ever been attracted to a friend's sister?
Oh, yeah.
And then it'll hit you like, oh, shit, it's like a girl version of him. Like, it's like... The body will suck you in, but then the face is like, oh, fuck, man, that's like, that's a female him, you know what I mean?
Winner in the chat, I agree, bro.
What do you say?
I agree. You might want to keep that to yourself, motherfucker.
No, it's a...
Threw the hand on my sister and shit on live radio, motherfucker.
Sister, what are you talking about? I've never fucking been on your
It's getting creepy. I agree.
It is creepy. That's my point.
It is creepy. Anyways, caller, you're live on WZI. What's up?
What's going on, fellas?
I can't.
How you doing, man?
Good, good. And one quick thing, Ryan, if you ever get rid of Matt, to steal the phrase from Christian, your WZR peeps would be rioting in the streets because the show isn't anything without him. So, anyway, to get to my call, I agree with you about Sandman's theme, but don't forget about Natural Born Killers and
Why can't I, hold on one second, man. Is it the AC?
Yeah.
Is that what's doing it?
It's louder than you think. They can't.
We got this all the way up, right? Yeah, it's all the way up.
I do.
Hold on. Yeah, it's all the way up. All right, I'm just going to have to put my head down here. All right, go. I'm sorry. Go ahead once again, man.
Oh, no. You said that Sandman's ECW theme was the best, but don't forget... New Jack with his
Yeah. Oh, you're right, dude. New Jack would come out, dude, and have the intro playing the entire time during matches.
And they would have that special
awesome.
Light, and they would keep the music.
That was
playing.
The original Gangsters theme, right? I think
it was Dr. Dre and Ice Cube. It was
right.
Original
Gangsters. I think it's Original Gangsters.
No. It's
like
actually
that.
A wimpy name of a song, but
is
it's
it?
Awesome.
Yeah. Caller, you're live on WZR TV. What's up?
What's going on, guy?
How you doing, man?
I'm your buddy from Chicago, man.
Hold on one second, dude. We're having a problem with hearing the callers tonight. We're gonna shut the we're gonna turn things down here. All right, hold up one second. All right, try now, man.
Hey, what's good? It's your buddy from Chicago, man.
Chicago, what's up, man?
Yeah,
shut down.
First off, I wanted to see if you noticed what I noticed yesterday when they were moving Daniel Bryan into the ambulance. Did you notice that? You know, basically the Stephanie teasing the match with Brie Bella.
Stephanie McMahon was teasing
Stephanie,
the match with who?
You got a good feeling that you think is he getting stripped of the title?
I don't. You know what? Is Daniel Bryan going to be stripped of the title? I think what's going to happen, man.
Yeah.
I think what's going to happen is, you know, Daniel's going to have surgery on Thursday. When they come out of surgery on Thursday, they're gonna get a better idea of how severe, how much time he's going to miss.
Yeah.
Now, if he only needs 4 to 8 weeks off or 6 to 8 weeks, whatever it is, if that's all the time that he needs off, they're not going to strip him of the title. They're going to bring him back, and he'll probably be back by Money in the Bank. But if they get bad news coming out of surgery on Thursday that he's going to need, you know, 3 months, 4 months, something like that, that's what it is, Natural Born Killers. You know, if he's going to need more than 4 to 8 or 6 to 8 weeks off, then they're going to have to go a different route and say, well, clearly we're going to have to take the title off Daniel Bryan, or we're going to have to strip him of the title. I think they're waiting until Thursday, and that's why they did the angle on Raw with Kane, they're waiting until Thursday to find out after surgery how things went.
We'll get a better idea. Definitively make any plans because they don't know how it's going to go.
Right. Exactly.
There's people saying we're different again, but
keep it going. So that's, I mean, Daniel Bryan, you know, announced the neck surgery on Raw last night with the promo that he cut. So,
yep.
Caller, you're live on WZR TV. What's up?
Call you there.
You're live. 3, 2, 1. Poof. All right, so he announces basically, you know, cuts a heartfelt promo that he is going to have neck surgery this Thursday,
mm-hmm.
and that was pretty much it, right?
And he said there's a chance he may never wrestle again.
It's not as serious as that.
But it's possible.
It's possible.
I mean, if something bad goes, I mean, there's been, didn't Kanye West's mom die from a botched surgery operation?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, and I think that was plastic surgery, too, which is really...
I know. We had John Cena.
I want to make my nose look prettier, and then you're dead. Like, oh, fuck.
I know. Not only that, dude, but listen, the people that undergo plastic surgery, while you're a young person, it'll make you look better. But as you grow older...
Look at Joan Rivers. Yeah.
You know, as you grow older, you think, man, why did I have that plastic
and
surgery?
And the Botox.
It's so bad.
Yeah.
It's so bad. These poor people. And some people, they say it's like an addiction, where these people become addicted to plastic surgery, and they go and they have more operations. And granted,
somebody gets a tattoo and they get addicted. I want this tattoo and this tattoo. If somebody gets a job, and they're like, oh, maybe I can fix my cheeks. Maybe I can fix my chin. Maybe.
They may fix my cheeks.
That was not a shot.
All right. I thought it was a subtle.
How many different facial parts?
I thought it was a subtle thing. Nose, eyes, chin. All right, no doubt. I thought it might have been a subtle.
A little insecure over there, buddy?
No, I thought it might have been a subtle shot.
He thinks he's got fat cheeks from drinking too much.
Yeah, I thought it might have been a subtle shot. I do have big cheeks. That's well known. Everybody can see my cheeks. I got big cheeks.
You look like Bo Dallas' sister.
I look like a chipmunk. I go chipmunk.
That was a funny joke.
Anyways.
I said you look like Bo Dallas' sister.
I look like,
it was a callback on the previous topic.
No, I look like,
chipmunks. He looks like a peanut M&M with his hat off.
Yes, the peanut M&M.
Yeah, if he took his hat off, he looked like either.
There's a cartoon character. What is it?
There was two jokes we used to do. Me and my boss, Brian Einhouse. Which, by the way, if he's watching, fuck you, Einhouse. I hope you die tomorrow. But I don't like him.
Whoa.
I don't like
him. He ain't gotta go that far.
He was a great friend.
I don't know about wishing really death upon somebody, man.
I really like that guy. He was my best buddy.
That's,
but
that's a lot.
He really fucked me. Right. But we would joke that you either look like.
You don't wish death upon him.
No. Anyways, if he dies tomorrow, I'm not crying. Let's put it that way.
You'd be upset, man.
I'd be upset, but I wouldn't cry.
That's not very nice. But anyway, you know, all right. So where are you going with this?
Fuck it. But
where are you going with this?
Yellow M&M, which was the peanut M&M,
yeah.
In the commercials with the red and yellow M&M, and B, Humpty Dumpty.
Humpty Dumpty. That's the one that
you
I'm
would
looking
say
for.
Like an egg. God. You got an egghead.
Guy fucking calls me Humpty Dumpty. Anyways, John Cena and the Usos against the Wyatt family. Cena pinned Eric Rowan, right?
Cena was
on Raw last night in this tag team
match. Yeah, how did we forget that?
I kept thinking, where
I was drunk.
Cena?
What's your excuse?
No, I kept thinking there was no Cena on Raw last night.
He didn't do a promo.
Yeah. And he was kind of thrown in a tag team match, too.
He didn't do a Renee Young thing before the match? Or no?
There was nothing. Okay. There was no Cena promo last night on Raw.
And he's booked for SmackDown.
Tonight.
Because most of the crew on Raw last night. Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
They're doing a European tour overseas.
Mm-hmm.
I think they start in Glasgow.
Tonight, I believe, right? Or tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night. Or tonight. Either way, they're going to the Europe market to do a tour.
So one crew flew out. The Raw crew flew out last
Basically
night.
Basically half the Raw roster that we saw last night left after the show to
I
go
think
to
the
Europe.
Wyatts are
going to
be on SmackDown as well. I think Cena,
there's
the Wyatts.
There's a lot of big names still. Yes, yeah, Cena, the Wyatts.
Somebody stayed, a couple guys, a couple top names stayed behind. So the Raw roster is currently overseas in Europe. SmackDown roster is going to take off later tonight. They're going to head overseas. By the way, next week's Raw and SmackDown are being taped from the O2 Arena in London.
Correct.
So we're going to have spoilers. The next week's Raw for you guys in the United States is going to be taped on about a 5-hour delay. So
Well, no, Daniel Bryan and a taped Raw. Do you think the rating will drop because of that?
Yeah, Daniel Bryan's clearly not
there'll
going
to there'll be
overseas.
No Daniel Bryan, and there'll be spoilers before the show. Will that fuck the rating up, you think?
I don't know, man.
And there's heavy competition with the playoffs in the NHL,
the playoffs
and basketball
everything else,
games.
Right, yeah. The rating for this week, we don't have the final number just yet.
It's
going to
be
but,
between a 2.8 and a 3.0.
It
was
think.
4 million viewers
good.
On the dot, which is the lowest score they've done since football season.
Since football season. Not only that, but it's lower as far as viewership is concerned. It's lower than last week, and last week
that's
they
what I said,
drew
the
a 3.
Lowest
0.
Since football
yeah.
season ended in January.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. Caller, you are live on WZR TV. What's going on?
What's going on, fellas?
How you doing, Matt?
Good. Hey, so with the push that we saw last night when Brie pushed Stephanie, is that going to lead to something you think maybe at the pay-per-view? Because I don't think she's going to be off TV now since her husband's gone, right? Or do you think that... Because Stephanie looked pretty pissed, like she was thinking of something. What do you guys think?
Yeah, they did the backstage segment.
Pretty pissed.
We know that you can hear. I got it. I'll take care of it. We had, you know, Bree did the segment backstage with Stephanie McMahon. They were loading Daniel Bryan into an ambulance. And yeah. Bree basically told her, you know, fuck off. Yeah, get out of here.
Yeah.
So the caller...
I thought she was going to smack her.
Yeah.
But she pushed her.
The caller is asking, is there a chance that Stephanie McMahon would get in the ring and do a match with Brie Bella?
Absolutely. Do I think they're doing that?
Yeah.
No.
That's what he's asking.
But is there a chance? Sure.
Yeah, I think it, I mean, right now it ties into the storyline. I mean, Payback is in a couple of weeks. I mean, if they are going to do it at Payback, they started the angle last night.
You know
we'll
what?
See what they do. We'll see what they do next week on Raw. I mean, if there's a confrontation between the two, I would say, yeah, why not at Payback? They started it last night with, you know, well, they started it the week before.
Weeks, yeah.
The week before
couple
they started
weeks.
It where, you know,
yeah,
Bree's,
yeah.
you know, kind of rolling her eyes at Stephanie.
Yeah.
And then last
well,
week.
Well, last week she told her to get out of the locker room or whatever the fuck.
Right,
you
know and then this week
yeah.
it led
or
to the push.
Her a bitch!
Right. And then this week it led to the push.
Yeah.
So next week maybe there'll be a brawl or something like that. And then where do they
and
go
because
from
Daniel Bryan's out with surgery or whatever and can't wrestle at Payback.
I would say Brie steps. There you
they
go.
They can keep the story going
I
by
like
having Brie and Stephanie. I think the caller might be onto something there.
Yeah, you may be onto something, man. I agree with that. Payback's in a couple of weeks, so we'll see what happens.
And by the way, the chat room was saying when we were talking about we couldn't hear the callers, like, oh, we hear them fine. We have the callers for you. You know, if you don't understand, we have it plugged straight to the computer we're recording it
right,
on.
Right, you guys can
so
hear.
So you guys hear them crystal clear. We're listening through a headphone that we're trying to... Like,
Moon's got a bad ear, too. He's
and
got
I don't
a,
hear well,
a
yeah.
Thing. I'm good. I can
oh, yeah, hear. And I got the hearing. It's coming
I
back.
I can hear most of you guys, so you're we're good to go. As long as I can hear you. Thanks for the call, bro.
Anything
I appreciate
else?
It. Anything else, man?
No. Oh, hey, who is... Alexander Rusev and the woman that comes out, was she in NXT as a diva? I mean, I never heard of her before until I saw her with him. Was she in
yeah, it's,
NXT?
It's Lena, man. Her name's Lena.
Yeah.
She was an NXT diva.
She's fucking smoking
the
hot.
The two of them are... Did you know that Rusev... How did Rusev land at Lena?
They weren't dating until they started the storyline in NXT. So they put them together in NXT, and then they really... Thanks to the call, he hung up. They really hooked up, and that happens very often.
Yeah.
Happens.
Oh, yeah. No
you're
doubt.
On the road that much, you don't have a chance to have much of a personal life.
I don't know if Fandango and Summer Rae are still dating.
No, they never were.
They were. They were in real life. Yes, they were.
Were in Total Divas, they weren't. They showed an episode where they tried to hook up.
Yeah.
And it's all fake Total Divas.
Right.
I'm using this as evidence. But they did an episode where Summer Rae was like talking... A bunch of Summer Rae's friends got married.
Okay.
And she's realizing, oh, I'm getting older, and all my friends are getting married, and I'm still single. I don't even have a serious boyfriend. I don't have any boyfriend. I'm just dating.
I know that Fandango, as of recently, he's been putting photos up of himself and Layla.
Yeah.
And I know on screen they're a couple in the angle right now.
They've been using social media to do everything with Fandango.
Yeah,
I broke up with Summer Rae.
But Layla and Fandango have both been posting photos where, like on a Saturday night, they're out at a bar together, and on a Sunday, on a weekend, where WWE's, you know,
they didn't have
live events this past weekend. And they were putting photos up.
The bar was part of Total Divas. They went to a bar. Like, Summer Rae, like I said, her friends were getting married, blah, 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 blah. She's like, oh, I'm single. I don't even have a serious boyfriend.
Right.
I'm getting older, and all my friends are getting married, and I'm still, you know. So she says, you know, I work with this guy, Fandango, and he's a really good-looking guy. Maybe I should ask him out. So she asks him out, they go on a date, they go to a bar.
Right.
Apparently this is a bar that Fandango goes to all what the time. And anyways, they go back to his apartment and she fucking jumps on him in her. And you can see the goddamn...
I saw the preview
curve
clip
in
for
her
that.
Back
right,
and
right.
her ass, she looks so fucking hot.
Something about
with her
face.
Face. Yeah,
her
she's
face,
got like a
right,
scar
right.
or something like
it's
going
the
on.
Nose, man. It's the nose.
The nose, too, but there's something on like the side of her cheek that's like...
Well, anyway,
what I'm
talking about is
look at that, though,
the bar photo. I
so
mean...
She gave him blue balls. You know what that is?
Blue balls?
Yeah.
She sucked his dick so hard that they got blue?
No, she got him hard and then left him hanging.
Ah.
She like fucking...
Well, if you're hard, you're not hanging.
No, she left him hanging.
Yeah,
see. She didn't let him
okay.
do anything with it.
Okay.
She hopped on him and devoured
yeah, yeah.
him and making out
that's
with him.
That's fucked up, man.
Rubbing her body into him. And then
that's
says,
fucked
you know
up.
What? We gotta stop. And I'm sorry, this was wrong. And it's like,
oh man.
Have you ever been in that position?
Wah, 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 wah.
Have you ever been in that position?
I have.
Have you really?
I have.
I haven't, but I can imagine it's fucking torture for a girl.
Janet did it to me the first time.
Really?
The first time.
Sometimes girls do that to make you want them even more.
I know.
You know?
I know.
Oh, God,
Janet
it's so
did it.
Fucked up for someone to do that. Like, how
on
would
the
you...
couch in East Greenbush.
So she's grinding
were there.
In India and then says, oh, we gotta stop.
Yeah.
Ooh, I could punch a bitch
yeah.
in the mouth for that shit.
Yeah, man.
And they know what they're doing. It's not like, oh, I just now realized. No, they plan that shit.
I know. Anyway, so,
fucking
but Fandango and Layla, they were at a bar and hanging out.
They called her a butterface and everything.
Walking down the street this weekend, and there were no WWE live events, so they were together over the weekend, despite there being no live events.
Do you think they're together for real?
I think Layla and Fandango may be dating as a real-life couple. I don't know that it's confirmed,
yeah, I have
but
no idea.
There were no live events this past weekend, yet Fandango and Layla were spotted together.
Ha!
You know, at and,
look at Buff Bagwell's latest post there in the chat.
So hard, his balls turned.
I asked you if you knew what blue balls were, and Buff Bagwell quoted him. He put posts, and then said, -- Ryan Clark. What's
sucked
blue balls?
Ball
according to Ryan Clark, it's when a girl...
Hey.
Sucked his dick so hard, his balls turned blue.
We don't hold back
right
here, do we? We don't hold
no.
back. I've never held back. All right, listen. Back
to the
honor
of blue balls. That'd
we're
going to
do, we're gonna do the high points and the low points
yes.
here so we can get through it and then talk a little bit of news and rumors over the past week. If you guys want to give us a call, it's 518-712-3070. 518-712-3070. So listen, pick up your
Hello?
Telephone. Pick up the telephone.
Am I on the air?
Pick it up.
Yeah.
I'm giving you an opportunity. You got your cell phone there? Ready?
Do you have a landline still? Or you know?
Hit these digits. Here we go. 518-712-3070. Give
call
us
up.
A call right now, 518-712-3070. Also, we're going to do rapid fire here in just a couple of minutes, facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. Evolution against the Shield at Payback. I did put rapid fire up.
You don't have Facebook loaded on there.
Oh, we'll get it up here
wait,
in a second.
I get that while we're talking.
Evolution and the Shield against, or they're going to face each other at
yeah, it was
Payback.
A big promo segment.
Let them know what happened here.
Evolution came to the ring.
Right.
They all took turns talking shit, blah, 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 blah. Long story short,
Evolution wound up.
Evolution
wound up running away. The Shield was in the ring, right?
Well, they
or Shield
came
out.
Came down and went to beat him down. And I think Stephanie called out. Is this where she called out all the heels, or was this the main event? I think it was the main event with Roman Reigns. I don't know. Is this where?
They brawled, and then Evolution wound up running away. They headed up the ramp,
right.
And that's where
well,
Batista gets pissed off.
You know what I'm talking about? The main event where Stephanie calls all, and like the whole heel locker room empties out.
Right.
Yeah, no,
Batista,
you're right. This was where.
Batista wound up getting pissed off here. He said, finally, I've had enough. I can't
yes.
take this anymore, so I want Roman Reigns tonight.
Yes.
The Roman winds up accepting, and we have a match later on in the evening. We had, oh boy, my laptop froze up here. We had,
to Sheamus versus, and then
it was a
know.
Quick match between Nikki Bella and Natalya as well.
That didn't happen yet. No, we go to Sheamus versus, and we didn't know if it was going to be Ryback or Curtis Axel because they both came out, and they like, they do rock, paper, scissors, shoot, you know.
Right.
And I guess they tied on that, so they... Ryback, I think, took his hat off and flipped a coin.
Right. Yeah, so Ryback doesn't know how to do the...
He did it
run
late. Yeah, you're supposed
right,
to go
right.
1, 2, 3, go. He did 1, 2, go.
Right.
Yeah, he fucked up. But So I forget who worked first. Who was it first? Was it Ryback?
Well,
or
that
Axel?
Nikki Bell and Natalya match happened before this. I'm just letting you
Where
know.
Where do you see that? Oh, okay, there, yeah, right there. Oh, and they shot an angle on that too. Like Natalya's either turning heel.
Well, they had the divas out there with cards.
The Total Divas.
Right, divas, and like it was basically cards. Like
if you're doing the Olympics and you're doing figure skating, yeah. They hold up a 6.9, 7.
Who was it that stood there? I think it was Cameron or Naomi.
Yeah, it was Naomi with a six
the
whole time.
Entire time, rolling her eyes like
that. Had to have been a backstage rib. Something. All right, so after the match, Natalya flipped out, which is funny because Alicia Fox flipped out early in the night. Now
yeah.
Natalya flipped, so they did.
Yeah.
But that was built off of an angle they did on Total Divas, which I watched this morning.
Yeah. Was it good?
Cringe. I mean, it's Total Divas. Yeah, I like the show. I got to admit, I like the show. I'm into it.
I know you download it every week, man.
Yeah.
You're on it.
I get really fucking horny watching it, too.
Oh, Jesus.
They're such little slutty fucking bitches, yo. The Bella Twins,
yeah,
in particular, are just so. And they wear these fucking outfits. Oh, man. They're such little. So they shot the angle based off the TV show Total Divas, where Natalya, I guess, is into painting. So she painted Cena and
I saw this.
Bella portrait for their housewarming.
It was
the second one. She painted a portrait of Cena and Nikki Bella,
right,
for their housewarming gift because Cena bought Nikki a house.
Check my nose.
Cena bought Nikki a house last week. So for the housewarming gift, she paints a picture. When Nikki, if you remember, when on the pier, she jumped on his arms.
Yeah. Right.
So she tried to paint a picture of that, and they didn't like it, blah, blah, blah.
How about them getting it to the arena where it that flies off the back of the car?
That was the second one that you're talking about, which was the wedding gift, which was to Daniel Bryan and Brie Bella. Mm. She decides for their gift, she's going to paint another picture, and this one's of them two and their dog,
right?
And it's another hideous picture, and Tyson Kidd fucks with it, like, yeah,
he's fucking with her.
I don't want nothing to do with it. I'm not touching it. And she's like, well, can you help me carry it? No, I don't even want to touch it.
I don't
want
to
see her
to
lugging this big, and right. I can't, like, right, this right. big fucking portrait. And
she puts it on top of the car, and she tries to tape it down with the fucking trainer's tape.
Not just that, they don't have you have a bike rack on top of your car.
They got a smart car.
They don't have anything up there, and they can't fit it in the car, so they put it on top. And
Natalya puts it on top.
Yeah, and because they don't have anything, she takes her stockings and tries to use that to strap it down, and they use some tape the stockings on the side of the car so that the stockings don't just fly out. Long story short, they start driving.
It flies off.
More than 5 miles, it's fucking gone.
Tyson's awesome. Because
Tyson's like, yo, I don't want to. He's like, we should just leave it.
Just leave it. I want nothing to do with it. And Tyson's like, yo, you don't listen to me. You don't listen to me. I told you we're going to fly off the car.
But they give that to Brie and Daniel. But anyways, the match between Nikki Bella and Natalya was based off the first painting we talked about. Because Nikki didn't like it.
Mm.
So she hides it. And when Natalya comes over to greet her and see her new house, they make sure to set it up, and,
All right, we had Stephanie McMahon comes out. She reacts to Daniel Bryan and his injury. You know, he's going to need surgery this Thursday, right?
Yeah,
she cuts a promo. Yeah. She apologizes. You know, she's apologetic, basically fucking with him. Eventually, she says, Daniel, will you come out here right now? I want to talk to you. I want to wish you well.
Yeah.
Kind of comes out. Kane winds up dragging him out.
Yeah.
This leads to the...
They go to commercial.
Right.
We come back from commercial, he's on a stretcher. Well, they put him on a stretcher before commercial. But anyways, we come back from commercial, he's on a stretcher. They're wheeling him to the ambulance. Outside the ambulance is Bree. Are you okay?
We talked about this.
And Stephanie, and then,
it leads to the push.
Bree pushes Stephanie.
We had Dolph Ziggler picked up a win over Fandango, of all people, on Raw. Right?
Well, they didn't do that last week. Who beat Fandango last week, Reese? Or was it this week where he said, I don't care?
Fandango's kind of getting a little push, huh?
Where he says, I don't care that I lost. I won tonight because I love...
Right.
Was that last night or was that last week?
I think it was on... it was last night. It was last night.
Yes, that was last night.
Last night.
God, that feels old.
We had Rusev, Big E, and the Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Oh, what'd you think of Hacksaw coming back on Raw?
Hacksaw retweeted me last night.
He retweeted me today.
Yeah, fucking guy. But somebody posted this graphic on my Facebook, which, and they always tag us, and I hate that shit because I got to untag it. But he tagged a photo of Rusev, and guess who everybody Rusev... Guess what is in common?
What's
in common with everybody that Rusev has worked with so far?
What
one trait do they all have in common?
Everybody they've all been squashed. Kofi Kingston.
And who do you have the handicap matches with?
All black.
All black.
All African American. Because
guess what? Kofi Kingston, R-Truth, Xavier Woods. Who did you work with last night?
Big E.
Big E.
Yeah.
They're all black.
Yeah.
I never even noticed that.
Huh.
I think there might be a racist writer on staff, and let's have him squash all the fucking black guys.
That is kind of
weird. Is that a coincidence that he's beating up all the black guys? I could see Kofi's kind of a jobber somewhat. R-Truth Xavier Woods kind of a jobber.
And then check this out.
Biggie's not a jobber.
I got one more for you. So, a big guy and Rusev. Let's see if Mark Henry comes back. Let's see if they do Rusev and Mark Henry.
That could be
big
next.
Big guy versus big
that
guy.
That could be next.
Two guys that kind of...
I wouldn't doubt it.
Huh?
I wouldn't doubt it. And Big E's a big guy. What are we talking about? He's a big fucking boy.
And we haven't seen Mark Henry in a while. He's out with the...
They had Lesnar trash him and then...
Mark Henry,
But I think
there's something.
I'm not on anything.
Or whoever,
somebody Facebooked me, and I'm like, you know what? I never thought of that. He also worked with Sin Cara, but he's Mexican, I guess. So they're like, yo, he's racist against anybody foreign, even though he's Russian or Bulgarian or whatever the fuck.
You see that, huh?
Lena is smoking hot, though.
What's going on there?
What?
I don't know. Anyways.
Oh, nobody's doing Facebook rapid fire.
Anyways, whatever.
They don't love us.
We still gotta get through Raw anyway.
Facebook.com/ Ryan Clark WZR. That's Facebook.com/ Ryan Clark WZR. This is your last chance. Get your questions. Get your comments. Facebook.com/ Ryan
Damien
Clark
Sandow WZR. And Cody Rhodes up on Raw. Cody Rhodes.
I wish I would have seen the Sandow promo, man.
Cody? You know what happened?
Okay.
He came up. It was on the pre-show. Jimmy Hart was on the pre-show panel last night.
The panel?
Yeah.
Okay.
Pre-show.
Did he have the megaphone?
I didn't see the pre-show, but I
know. Baby.
So, Damian Sandow.
You watch Legends House?
I see the highlight clips that come online, but I haven't watched the full.
They're doing this.
What's up with Tony Atlas and Hacksaw?
That's the thing. They're doing this. I think it's like the whole storyline, the main event storyline of the whole spread of the shows.
They're gonna fight.
Is that eventually these two are gonna fucking go at it?
What's the beef?
Like the last time we went off the air, Thursday night. Is it Thursday?
Yeah.
Okay, the last time the show went off the air, like, the last thing they did was do this big build-up to where these two, like...
Is that the clip that I saw where Hacksaw's like, I've never backed down from anybody, but I'm not backing down to this guy.
That was sort of...
Yo, at the end of the video, he does this. I'm not backing down to this guy.
When they do the talking heads. But it was during the middle of the show they did that. And then towards the end of the show, something happened. I was drunk as shit when I watched it.
Yeah.
But there was something towards the end where, like, the music's playing.
And
it's this big fucking build-up. Oh, these
just
two are
like,
going to eventually go
like
at it.
Total Divas,
Yeah. It really is. It's the guy Total Divas.
Remember the whole... Total Divas. Did you ever see where John Cena... Is waiting on the fucking
the
pier.
Yeah,
and Nikki walks in. They got the music.
The music and then the wind's blowing. And
Oh god.
Yeah.
All right.
Do you think that the Total Divas is a big? Because the big storyline is Cena will never get married, ever have kids.
Yeah.
Because he got married before. You guys heartbroken.
You think? I know where you're
going
with this.
Is it a big long build up to where the big culmination is Cena finally proposes, and then we get the big Cena Bella wedding.
Do you think that's
where they're going?
I don't think so, man. I don't think so.
I don't know.
Let's
put it this way. I don't think so either.
Yeah.
But would I be surprised if they did it?
Would they do a fate? No. They couldn't do... They couldn't go that
because you have to do a license.
There's licenses and everything else,
it would be paperwork. But I don't expect it.
Yeah.
But would I be surprised if it happened?
Yeah.
Fuck no.
Yeah.
Fuck no. That's
sure
the whole build
to pressure up. Him into it.
No shit.
Yeah.
I'm
yeah.
sure she is.
Yeah. yeah. Well, of course she is.
Yeah, she wants that ring and have his fucking loot.
Poor Cody Rhodes, man. I mean, listen. The dude's got all the potential in the world. It's the same thing. Curtis Axel. I think Curtis
Does
Axel.
Does he have all the potential in the world?
Listen. Curtis Axel. Okay.
He's a good worker, but.
Curtis Axel's let's. Forget Cody Rhodes.
Okay.
Curtis Axel is the type of guy that, listen, let's be honest, he's a decent in-ring worker, but he doesn't charisma.
He doesn't have it,
right?
Yeah.
If you were to take Curtis Axel, and it's a little bit too late now, but when you first brought him up, you bring him in, and you have him do the same gimmick as his father. And you have him be perfect. No. You have him be perfect at everything. But the problem with that is Curtis Axel's the type of guy that he's not good enough where he'd be in the ring and he'd fuck up a spot or something like that and it wouldn't be perfect.
Not that. I just
I don't know, man. You gotta do something.
Nothing is as good as the original. The only example that I can come up with in, as far as wrestling, as far as nothing is better than the original, is the Nature Boy.
Mr. Perfect.
The Nature Boy.
This dude's father.
Buddy Rogers.
Is this dude's father.
The Nature Boy, Buddy Rogers, was a legend.
Yeah.
And nothing's better than the original in wrestling, but Ric Flair fucking blew away Buddy Rogers with that Nature Boy shit.
Mr. Perfect.
And it was all stolen.
Is this
Struts, the figure four,
father.
Blonde hair.
Mr. Perfect is this dude's father. And you're telling me that they're not even going to try to do something?
Well, something.
They barely mentioned that Mr. Perfect is Curtis Axel's father. They barely brought it up.
No. At first they did, for what,
2 or 3 weeks?
No, for a couple months. Before Axel, when he was McGillicuddy.
Right, Michael McGillicuddy.
Yeah, they would bring it up all the time. But the problem there is, if you have him be a reincarnation of an old fucking 80s popular gimmick, that puts a ceiling on you. The best you're going to get is a mid-card guy because you got this gimmick that's a recycled gimmick of your dad. You can't be a main eventer with that style. And the idea is, like, these all guys...
Don't recycle the gimmick to a T, but do some sort of takeoff.
If you copy it or reference it in any way, you're putting a ceiling on him. You're capping him.
You're capping
his potential because, at best, he's going to be a mid-card comedy or gimmick act.
Yeah.
Everybody needs at least to have the chance... to take whatever they got and go main event. Now, there's exceptions. Santino, no matter how good he is never going to be a main event guy with his gimmick.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and there's a billion other examples. Eugene back in the day, whatever. There's guys that they slap a gimmick on where no matter what they do, they're not getting past mid-card.
Yeah.
But if you throw
Cody Rhodes is one of those guys, by the way.
No, he doesn't really have a gimmick.
But he's Cody Rhodes is always going to be one of those guys that no matter what he's always going to
be... No, I agree.
You know?
But I'm talking about the gimmick they place on a guy.
Yeah.
If you place a certain gimmick on a guy, like a Mr. Perfect remake, you're never going to be main event with that.
Right.
Cody Rhodes doesn't have a gimmick where, like, yo, they gave him this Cody Rhodes gimmick where he'll never, no matter how good he is, if he's good enough, he could take Cody Rhodes because there is no gimmick there, really. He's just Cody Rhodes. If he's good enough and he breaks through enough, he could be the main event guy. If you have a guy trapped in the walls of you're the second Mr. Perfect, that's never going to go to the top.
I know. You're right. You know? You're right. God, I feel like I'm...
Why do you always put your beers in
I feel like Red Robin. We're advertising Red Robin.
That's our commercial sponsor. They don't see
this
it.
This is our sponsor.
I'm looking at the screen. I can't
tell. All right, no doubt.
Well, why do you always put your beer in a cup? Why do you do that?
I don't like drinking out of cans.
I prefer a can so
really?
Much. I hate drinking
out of
cup.
Well, yeah, but when you go to a bar,
then you have
in a glass cup like this.
You get drunker for some reason.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right.
When you drink out of a cup.
We got to finish up, Raw, because we
got
to get out of here.
We really got to, but
SmackDown's on the East Coast, so I want to get out of here early. All right, so...
Shayla's taking care of it. I ain't going to do nothing.
Yeah, no. We're at the main event, dude. Batista and Roman Reigns, right? This went to a no contest here. It was basically...
Well, you know what? They did. Bray challenged Cena to a last man standing match.
Oh, they did.
You're right. I'm wrong. There you go.
Yes, sir.
Right. Woo! Ho! Tough guy!
Boone and I have been fucking with each other.
USA! But, Batista, Roman Reigns, the leader of the Shield, I guess, versus the big guy of Evolution. Even
I know. Roman Reigns, the leader
Batista
of the Shield,
is kind
bro.
Of not the biggest guy anymore. You know, used to be. But, so they did that match, and then go ahead.
No, I'm just you just referenced Roman Reigns as the leader of the Shield. We were
talking
about it earlier.
Yeah.
Dean Ambrose is kind of the leader.
He's
at first,
clearly the breakout guy of the
right,
Shield.
Right, absolutely.
Yeah.
Let's see. We had a Shield at the end of the match. Shield cleared the ring and celebrated, and then Evolution looked on from the stage.
Stephanie calls out all the heels.
That's
what happened there.
Shield beat them down, though.
Shield ends up getting through them all, and the last thing we see is, I think Evolution runs away, right?
Evolution. The
Shield
show goes off
better.
The air with Evolution on the stage.
Backpedaling.
Looking.
Yeah.
Looking down at the Shield.
Exactly.
So they made the Shield look like, whoa.
Last but. Night,
you know?
That's because we're still a few weeks away from Payback.
True.
By the time we get to Payback, the last scene will be probably Evolution stomping them out and leaving them.
Right, exactly.
But if Shield goes over, then it's done right.
All right, let's do some rapid fire.
Let's do it.
Here we go.
Hit a refresh, just in case.
I just did. I just did a couple minutes ago. I'll do it one more time, though.
Why not? One more chance.
We'll give it one more shot. If you guys want to call up in the next 10 minutes as well.
518-712-3070.
Let me start it out here. Anthony Remy, thoughts on the TNA releases? Hernandez was
not released as much as their contracts expired.
Frankie Kazarian.
Yeah, they didn't fire these guys.
Right.
Their contracts ran up, and in the case of Daniels...
Saban.
And I don't know which specific cases, but in some cases, I know Daniel specifically.
Hernandez as well.
No. Daniel specifically was offered a contract renewal, but the offer was not good enough, and he turned it down.
Right.
Hernandez, his
that was Saban.
His shit,
that was Saban as well.
Yeah, and Saban as well. I guess I don't know. I don't remember the Saban one. I know he was
Saban. Saban was
bottom line.
A new
some guys' contracts just expired and they're done. Other guys, their contracts expired. They were offered a new deal and they said no, fuck you, and they turned it down.
Right.
So
Saban, I know.
For example, there's a chance
website.
Hernandez might come back because maybe they offer something. Maybe he takes it.
Hernandez is a big deal overseas
in
Mexico.
That's not overseas. So,
not overseas. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, in a different
country.
In the foreign market.
So Chris Saban, I know, contract expired. They offered him to sign a new deal, and he said no, thank you. You're saying the same thing with
while
Daniels.
While we're on the topic, you got to run this story down because it's very interesting. The production. TNA.
Yeah, the production team, apparently there's been problems with late checks, right?
They're behind on pay.
Late payments. And at last week's
To the crew.
To the production
crew. The crew.
At last week's production, last week's TV tapings, the TNA production crew kind of bonded together.
This past weekend,
bonded together and basically said, "Listen, a lot of us haven't been paid. We are going to walk out on you." And
all of us.
TNA was able to resolve the issue. Now, what is the deal? I mean, Panda Energy is $1 billion company.
Multi.
I get that. Multi-billion-dollar company, and I get that, but I think you know Panda has.
They've only
TNA,
got a certain budget.
Panda has TNA on a budget, exactly where they get a certain amount of money.
Okay.
Now, what I mean is it just the case of you know why aren't these checks being sent? We don't know the reason behind it.
But Daddy, can I get a couple hundred more million?
Yeah,
please?
But we don't know the.
I could get Hulk Hogan again.
We don't know the reason behind why these checks are late. No, I mean. There's no excuse for it. Checks should not be late. I mean, if they're issuing checks late, there's a problem. There's no excuse whatsoever. But what the reason behind it is, we don't know the exact details. But problem is, production crew offered to walk out this past week. So what do we got?
Anthony Russell Lettuce. Wow, what the here he goes. That's going to happen the whole rest of the show.
He
does that with me, too. Look, 74 new ones. He'll do 90,000 in a row. Anyways, it's Acer, Vincent Nugent. Anthony Russell left, here he goes. Do you think they should strip the titles away from Daniel Bryan? If so, do you see a type of battle royal
for the titles? Like we said earlier, it all depends on Thursday.
How things
After surgery on Thursday, we'll get a better idea of how long Daniel Bryan's going to be out, this, that, and the other.
Let's go with this hypothetical situation. Say they strip him. How do they crown a new champion? Do they do a battle royal? I say no.
They've done too many battle royals to
They do a tournament like they did with the IC.
I agree.
Yeah.
I agree. Do some sort of tournament.
The finals on a pay-per-view. Yeah.
And not only that, but Raw ratings are down. You've got stiff competition. A tournament is a way to get people to come back every week. You know, hopefully, they don't have to do that, though.
I don't think they will, but it's...
I think surgery will be okay.
Ooh,
it's
I like
minimally,
the next question.
Minimally invasive surgery.
Yeah, so they don't have to really fucking cut them up. You know.
You like the next one? Go ahead.
Lance Winter, Mr. Winter's Lair, whose ass I would
kick. Is that Winter's Lair?
Yeah, whose ass I would kick repeatedly in fantasy football, which I can't wait to start up again. Johnny Manziel.
We were talking about that
the
other day.
By
the
Browns. Yeah, but,
very late,
anything from the NFL draft you want
late.
To mention? Is there any
I'm not happy that Stevie Johnson was traded away by the Buffalo Bills.
Stevie Johnson was your QB?
Wide receiver.
Wide receiver.
Yeah. We got a rookie wide receiver who's coming in. I can't remember
you drafted
his name.
One?
Sorry, guys. Yes, we drafted a rookie
first round?
Wide receiver in the first round.
Okay.
We also traded a couple of picks, but we got rid of Stevie Johnson.
Who did the Lions get, do you know?
People are saying the Lions draft was pretty bad.
Bad.
Yes, bad. Not good. Fuck. Not good.
But they take it. They took a defensive guy, right?
I think so. In the first, I don't remember.
All right. All right. Anyways, Lance Winter, Mr. Winter's Lair, whose ass I would kick all the time in fantasy football.
Brown versus
says Matt Brown versus Eric Silva, UFC fight of the year so far.
I still need to go back and watch the full fight. But
you
didn't. Yes.
I thought you did watch it.
No, I told you I missed the first round.
You said
you woke up. I woke up, but I missed the first round, which you said was the most amazing
round.
That
was supposedly the round of the, maybe the round of the century.
So I need to go back and watch.
The one time
I woke
up
about halfway through the second round, and then the rest of the
fight. Well, supposedly the second round was really good, too, from what I heard. But the first round was, like, out of this world, because Brown got knocked down with a big body kick. I saw the highlights, and I heard all the I watched the post-fight press conference. I watched Dana White's media scrum.
Right.
I listened to Meltz's post-radio show. Right. So I heard all the breakdown of the discussion of
the fight. It was a great fight, right?
And all I saw was ESPN runs, or Fox Sports, I'm sorry, runs highlights of the fight. I saw the highlights.
Okay.
He gets blasted with a body kick. And, I mean, and it, if you're, you've been hitting a body. I remember I dropped you with a body punch once, and you've hit me in the body many times. But, if you've been hit with a body punch and you or a kick or whatever, like if you've been hitting the body real hard, you know. And especially if you've been hit, if you've been punching the face real hard before, I've never punched in the face. But if you've been hitting the face real hard before, you can take that. It's not even really a big deal. It's you would think before you
your adrenaline's
if you've never been punched in the face before, in your mind you're like, oh god, that would hurt. It would suck. It doesn't hurt that bad at all, really.
Right.
Hitting the body. It hurts.
It hurts.
It
like
fucking hurts. And you see this kick, pow! I mean, he gets fucking blasted with this body kick, and he just crumbles like you do when you get hit in the body. And Silva follows up. You would swear to God he's getting TKO'd. Somehow, Herb Dean, best referee in the business, lets him fight his way out. Back up we go.
I'll have to check it out, dude.
They go back and forth. I see you're rushing. But, yeah, anyways, maybe was it the best fight of the year so far? 2014? Yes.
Christopher Brown, I'm going to go back and watch it. Christopher Brown, okay, for the record, some
Science
people are speculating that...
Palisades.
Yeah, it's weird, man. It's
the only one.
Yeah. Who is this? No.
Look at this name, this name, this name. That's the only one.
Italicized, what are you talking
like
about?
Crooked.
It's not crooked.
Oh, maybe your vantage point. Okay, anyways, what did Christopher Brown say?
Okay, for the record, people are speculating that Daniel Bryan broke his neck on the dive off the forklift on the cane.
Yeah?
Have you heard that?
I don't know if that's what happened. I've heard it was a wear and tear thing.
Who stands to benefit the most at payback with Daniel Bryan out? Dolph Ziggler offered to step up today.
And they're going
to
run with Dolph Ziggler.
Yeah, right.
But, didn't he just job on Monday? No, he beat Fandango. But,
Fandango.
Anyways.
John Morgan.
It's very fucked up.
It's kinda
what
fucked
do
up,
you guys think about the idea of WWE using Undertaker's streak to name Brock Lesnar as an uncrowned champion? WWE, I posted the idea on your comments a few days ago, but wanted to know what you thought about it. Give Lesnar an undefeated streak of his own on pay-per-view with all of his matches on pay-per-view, hyping him up as an uncrowned champ, and then have someone like Roman Reigns finally end the streak of Lesnar's.
It's a good idea. I mean, it'd be a cool idea to do something like you've got to do something with the Undertaker breaking the
streak. With Brock Lesnar breaking the streak. I wrote this column for E-Wrestling News. It was a two-parter, top 10.
Mm-hmm.
I always put the top 10 in two because I like I do here, I babble.
Right.
So when I do a top 10. Five is like three fucking pages. I don't need a six page.
I know. I tell him all the time, shut your fucking. I can't do it, man. I can't do it.
Yeah,
I can't
do
it.
Just do a smaller one. Just write a quick thought. I'm like,
you
no.
You can't fucking do it, man.
I want it to be a nice column. A blog is when you just jot your
if
thoughts.
If you ain't
down.
Never read this guy's columns, thank I'm you. Telling you, man. It, they're fucking amazing. And all the feedback he gets on them every time.
People dig them.
99% of the feedback is, yo, this column is fucking
thank
amazing.
Thank you very much.
So.
The one I posted today wasn't that great, but. Daniel Bryan,
even your worst column's pretty fucking good.
I got good,
good
comments on that one too.
Good,
I thought
man.
It sucked though. It was talk about bad luck.
Check them out at eWrestlingNews.com.
Thank you. But I wrote a top 10 on Steve Austin. It was top 10 guys Steve Austin should return to wrestle. And I only had Brock Lesnar like fourth or fifth.
Mm-hmm.
But as I was writing it, and I because what I do is I look at the WWE roster. Mm-hmm. Then I look at Hall of Famers in case somebody maybe comes out of retirement. Like, oh, The Rock will come back. Even though he's not on the roster, maybe Brock Austin. But anyway,
real quick, they're talking about The Rock, Mickey James, and Rikishi for
Hall of Fame,
okay.
Yes, next year. So I look at the roster, I look at guys that are retired but maybe could still work, and I list everybody I think of. So I got like 13 names. All right, I got to whittle it down to 10. Get rid of those three. All right, so now you got 10 names. Rank them. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I rank them.
Right.
Then I go bottom up, 10, 9, 8, and I write my little paragraph for each thing, why, in this specific case, Austin should return to wrestle this guy. Mm-hmm. By the time I get to Brock, who I had ranked when I ranked him beforehand at number 4 or 5, I'm writing the my thoughts on it, and I'm like, as I get to the end, I think I even say it in the column, I'm like, fuck, man, I probably should have ranked him higher. Because it would be such a perfect... He ends the streak.
Yeah.
How do you follow up on Brock Lesnar ending the streak?
I don't know.
You bring Stone Cold Steve Austin, the biggest star ever, who, by the way, A...
He's open to another match.
A, Paul Heyman was on Austin's podcast and talked about... And this is B.
How was that podcast, by
awesome.
The way?
And the Bischoff ones, which there's three of them, they're great too. Really, but okay. Heyman talks about Lesnar Austin. Did you know that those two have never had... I don't think they've ever wrestled at all.
Austin Lesnar?
Yeah.
Really?
I know they were supposed to, and Austin walked out. Yeah. And that was the big thing, the King of the Ring qualifier match. But
that's when Austin walked out with the Lesnar stuff.
They told him on Raw, unadvertised, no promotion, no build-up, you're going to lose to Brock Lesnar tonight on Raw in a King
of
the Ring.
No build-up for Austin Lesnar.
In the King of the Ring qualifier match. You're the guy that he's going to squash.
I don't blame him for walking out.
Oh, shit. Me neither. That was stupid. But either way, I don't think they ever did a match with Austin Lesnar. If they did, they never did a high-profile match, certainly never a pay-per-view match.
Right.
If Austin comes back, Lesnar just ends the Undertaker streak.
Mm-hmm.
Now, at this point, he's a former UFC champion.
Right.
NCAA champion. He's got mm-hmm. Paul Heyman as his mouthpiece. Imagine Heyman and Austin going back and forth on promos. Imagine the first time you see these two megastars, never have wrestled before, now they're going at it. Lesnar ends the streak. What's he do at WrestleMania next year? Oh, my God. Austin's coming back. And fucking Lesnar's beat the shit out of
the
him,
the only
too.
Match...
Now Lesnar is way up here, and the guy that finally beats him really gets a rub.
The only match that Austin wants to come back for is CM Punk. Is CM Punk.
And that was who I had number one. On my top 10.
I think the only match that Steve Austin wants to do a match with is
the quote I wrote was, alright, CM Punk says he's never returning, blah, 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 blah. You tell me, if Stone Cold Steve Austin calls CM Punk and says, yo, I want to return for a match. I've only got one in me. I don't want to work with anybody but you.
Right.
Is Punk going to say, I'm sorry, Steve, I'm retired?
No, we all...
He's going to say, hey, Vince, I'm
money,
ready to come back.
That's money in everybody's pockets. All right, here we go. Arturo Velasquez Jr., how long will the feud between The Shield and Evolution last?
This is it, I think.
You think this is it?
I pay back. I think this is it. I think they split now.
I think they're going to do Triple H Roman Reigns at SummerSlam.
Now,
and maybe a tag team match between Ambrose and Rollins against...
Batista and Orton, that's what I was going to say. Now, Evolution Shield, as far as 3-on-3 matches...
3-on-3?
This is it.
This is it.
But the feud itself, the program, may continue with...
I agree. Roman Reigns and Triple H.
Exactly.
And then a tag team match with Rollins, Reigns...
And that part I don't know about, because Batista might be taking
not
time
Not Rollins, Reigns. Rollins, Ambrose, and Orton.
Batista. But Batista
we'll
might
see
be
what happens with Batista.
Batista, I know he has to take off...
With the movie.
...by the time Guardians of the Galaxy comes out, which is in August, I think.
Right.
So no
but
SummerSlam.
But that's after SummerSlam.
No, that's before SummerSlam or during. It would be his build-up or SummerSlam itself would be...
They can do the tag team match before he goes
away. They
could
do Money in the Bank.
Money in the Bank. They can do a tag team match there.
But they're not blowing off Triple H Reigns.
Reigns and Triple
That's
H
SummerSlam.
Will be at SummerSlam. Yeah. No doubt. They'll continue that feud, but the tag team match, they can do it
right. In a sense, Evolution and The Shield will continue probably through the summer.
Right.
Will the 3-on-3 happen after June 1st?
Payback.
I don't think so. Yeah.
What do we got next?
Nugent says, and this is Acer, by the way, one of our favorites.
Yes, sir.
Any... Latest? Is that what that is?
Latest developments.
Latest developments for TNA from certain talents not getting good enough pay. Are the TNA talent angry / upset with their pay? What are your thoughts?
You notice that the guys at the re-signing, John Gaborik, comes out
Gaborik.
Basically says...
Or Gaborik, I'm sorry.
Gaborik.
I used to say Gaborik.
Robbie E. is re-signed and
James Storm, Blackstar Spud.
People like that. I mean, it's the lower
Ram.
End of the roster. Yeah. So, I mean, they're re-signing these names, but they're not top names. As far as people, you know, when their contracts...
They're not willing to pay top dollar
when
anymore.
When TNA Stars contracts expire, they are trying to get these guys to take a decrease in...
They're trying.
They all.
They're either you're they're taking all. A cut or
you're
out of here.
Or you're out. And a lot of guys.
A lot of guys are out. AJ Styles.
All these guys are saying, I'm not taking a pay cut.
Exactly. I can make more in Japan on the indies
work the indies around
That's
the United
what I just
States
said.
Or in
Japan.
Right, right.
Indies, Mexico. I can make more doing that than taking a shit pay cut
to
stay here.
The people that they're re-signing, they're re-signing a bunch of guys to multi-year contracts.
Yeah.
This, that, and the other thing. But Stupid, rock star spot. Yeah, it's crazy.
It's a waste of money.
Anthony Remy's back, giving a live feedback on Rapid Fire. Good show tonight, but running down Raw through hour numero dos, not good. We gotta finish.
We do that
Raw
every week.
Well, we kind of.
We never finish Raw on hour one ever.
Vincent Nugent back with one more. I know.
And Vincent Nugent, yeah, Anthony.
We're
Remy
going overtime for you tonight.
He's got the WZR T-shirt. Finally, you finally gave it to him, Vincent.
Yes, sir.
Anthony Remy. Vincent Nugent says you guys should start the show on time.
Wow, instead we were 3 minutes late.
Instead of being 5-10 minutes late after. That's my comment on it, boys. Improve on that.
We were 3 minutes late.
He's right. Does a TV show ever start?
I had problems with the Facebook.
Does a TV show ever start on 8:03?
No.
We're a web show. We're not a radio show. We're a internet television program.
Mm-hmm.
We should be here on time, which is why when you were brushing your motherfucking teeth, like you said at the beginning of the show, I said, "Dude,
why throw it on me? I didn't throw it on me."
I said, "Yo, nobody can smell your breath on the camera. Get the fuck out of there and let's go." You know, that's what I said.
Go brush your fucking teeth.
Ah, fuck. I did brush my teeth.
Christopher Brown, the last and final one. Just want to let you guys know the Sheamus Cesaro match on Main Event ended in a double countout. But will we see these guys at Payback? Sheamus and Cesaro?
I say yes.
I say yes.
That sounds about right. Especially with the international tour. Those two working together makes sense.
You know what else sounds about right? It's 10:09 Eastern Time on a Tuesday night. And that, my friend, is another edition of WZR TV Tuesday. Submit some feedback. Tell them where they can submit feedback.
Well,
you tell them.
Well, for the love of Christ, I say you go to Facebook.com/... Go ahead. Matt Boone, WCR.
Are you fucking kidding me right now, man?
Matt.
Are you serious?
He got some beer in his shirt. Facebook.com/MattBooneWZR. Or you go.
I say you go to Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR.
Let us know what you thought. What did you like tonight? You let us know, we'll do more of it. What didn't you like tonight? Did you not like me spilling beer over his shirt? You tell me, we'd do less of it. Facebook.com/MattBooneWZR. Facebook.com/MattBooneWZR.
Get out of here.
Look at it.
Get the
fuck, man. All over my arm.
Facebook.com/RyanWZR. Guys, always doing stupid shit. We're out of here.
Yes.
For Matt Boone.
That's me.
Do you want one? This is Ryan Clark.
That's him.
He's saying, see you next Tuesday night, 8-10 Eastern Time on WZROnline.com.